laws impose unconstitutional classifications on the basis of gender in violation of the Equal Protection Clause of the 14th Amendment to the United States Constitution. Aaron Sadler, press secretary to Arkansas Attorney General Dustin McDaniel, said the judge issued a stay, meaning the law will stay in effect while appeals are heard. An attorney for the plaintiffs said he was reviewing the decision and considering whether to appeal the stay. The decision in Arkansas comes after the U.S. Supreme Court last week cleared the way for South Carolina to become the 35th U.S. state where same-sex marriage is legal, denying a request to block same-sex wedding proceedings. While same-sex marriage advocates have had the upper hand in the courts in the past year, a Cincinnati-based federal appeals court on November 6th became the first court to uphold a marriage ban. That decision by the 6th U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals created a split within the court, increasing the chances that the U.S. Supreme Court will rule on the issue. Hi, I'm Daryl W. Perry, and I need your help to take Peace, Love, Liberty Radio on the road. During the 104-day trip, I'll be visiting at least 10 cities across the country, speaking to people about the ideas of peace, love, and liberty, while simultaneously continuing to create daily Liberty Media. To find out more about the tour or to donate, visit tour.fppradio.com. That's tour.fppradio.com. UPI reports thousands protested an attempt by police to clear part of Hong Kong's protest encampment, and over 30 people were detained on Tuesday. Hundreds of police officers descended on a 50-yard stretch of the city's Argyle Street in the commercial Mong Kok neighborhood to enforce an injunction against the occupation by protesters who were demanding municipal elections be free of involvement from the Beijing government. After issuing warnings by megaphone to vacate, protesters and onlookers were ordered to disperse. About a dozen of the remaining protesters were arrested. One protester told the Telegraph, "I will stay here until the very end because this is my home. If we lose this site and this battle, then the Chinese Communist Party will take full control of Hong Kong and it will no longer be the home I know." By Tuesday evening, an increased number of demonstrators had regrouped and scuffles broke out across the neighborhood between police and members of the crowd. Police said 32 people were arrested. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Sources within the Vatican confirmed Tuesday that Pope Benedict XVI has dispatched an elite team of six bishops to sabotage leading contraceptive manufacturer Pfizer. Codenamed Conclave 6, the highly trained team of bishops will reportedly infiltrate the heavily guarded compound, detonate extremely powerful charges at key points within the factory, and then escape to a nearby safe house.
The Catholic Church can trust only the best with defending God's plan. Conclave 6 is the deadliest team of bishops I've ever laid eyes on.
The Pope denied rumors that a B-team of needle-wielding priests had been deployed to a latex factory in New Jersey to poke tiny holes into thousands of Durex condoms. Locally, the best part of a gay 12-year-old's day is the half hour he spends eating lunch alone in a stairwell. Calling it his only respite from constant ridicule and mockery, 7th grader Ben McElroy says life doesn't get better than the moments he spends quietly laying out his lunch on a secluded staircase while the rest of his classmates are in the cafeteria.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up whatever's on your mind, and I'd like to let our board operator know that we are getting talkback from our ISDN line. Just for those of you who are new to the show, we do the show from Keene, New Hampshire, and it is very snowy here in Keene, New Hampshire tonight. There's expected to be something like a foot of snow, which for the end of November, I guess, isn't unprecedented here in New Hampshire. Joining me tonight, welcome
Derrick J.
And Chris Cantwell.
So, yeah, we'll talk about, of course, whatever's on your mind. You're welcome to join us here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. Despite the snowy situation out there, Chris Cantwell, your power went out earlier today. We do have power here at the studios. We've got battery backup, generator, two internet connections. So hopefully, even if certain lines go down, we should be able to continue the broadcast from the snowy winter wonderland that is New Hampshire at the moment.
So you did manage to get a UPS then?
No. No, I had one in the back room. I wanted to get another one. There were some technical difficulties in the studio earlier here tonight. Of course, it's, you know, during a time like this that a UPS will go on the fritz and malfunction. The battery, UPS being uninterruptible power supply, battery backup for your electronic devices. The battery is fine. I checked the battery voltage. That's fine. So I think that the box itself, you know, the device itself is just, it's whacked. And, like, the power just kept cycling on and off and on and off, and so it was pretty messed up.
Those things are finicky devices, and especially, you know, you try to save a couple of bucks on them. You think that you get a good deal. What brand is it, if you don't mind?
I think it's APC brand. I mean, it's not a bad brand.
Oh, okay, because APC is a pretty good one, and I've tried to buy, like, I used to work in a data center, and we try to buy UPSs, and you can get them, you know, for, you know, 40%, 30% of the cost of a brand name device, yeah. But you get them, and of course...
You get what you pay for.
Exactly, and they just plain don't work, and you end up in these situations, but APC is a pretty solid brand. I'm surprised.
Well, you know, it's been in service for a long time too, and normally when a product like that is in service for a long time, the thing that goes wrong with it is the battery dies. You know, it just doesn't hold a charge anymore, and you have to get another battery to replace.
And you get some kind of notification, some warning beep ahead of time.
Typically,
it doesn't happen in the snowstorm.
But yeah, that's how it goes sometimes. Machines break. So here we are. Toll free numbers 855-450-FREE. But some machines, like the justice system. They are well oiled, as we discovered today. Well, maybe not. Derrick J., you were on not trial.
It was
a hearing.
Hearing on the merits.
On what the merits of you being denied your supposed right to bear arms, specifically to not bear it, I guess, but to conceal your arms in this particular case. Because in New Hampshire, where we live, it's completely legal to open carry, unless you're a felon, I guess. But so, you know, the average person, you want to open carry a firearm.
Anybody who can own a firearm in New Hampshire can carry a firearm as long as it's not concealed.
Right. And I think that if you are, if you're under 21, you can be given like a certain type of firearm that you can't purchase. But even if you're given, was it a rifle or a handgun?
I say
handgun, maybe.
I believe it's even 18. I'm not sure that there's an under 21 restriction on firearms at all in New Hampshire. I'm not sure. This is not legal advice. Yeah. I never heard of 21.
Okay. I could be wrong about that. But
me too.
It's my understanding that that you know, even older teenagers who have a pistol, it may not be legal for them to buy the pistol, but possessing it is legal, and they could open carry well. But concealed carry, you have to get what's called a shall issue permit. And
a license, as they refer to it. One of the things I found funny.
Yeah, they don't
about
call it a permit.
They call
here.
It a license.
Yeah,
yes.
And it's funny, and I've talked to people in New Hampshire about this because if you look at like Pro Gun New Hampshire has this whole thing about like that's one of the things New Hampshire's really good about. I mean, you know, imagine you had to get a marriage permit. You know, it's a license because you have a right to do it. And I'm like, this is ridiculous.
That's ridiculous.
It is. It's so silly. You have to get permission from the state to do it, and they think it's better because it's a license. And I'm like, you're all fools.
That's like calling a tax a fee, and all of a sudden it's different.
It's so much better that you pay a marriage fee instead of a marriage tax. So, yeah, it's crazy that they say that, but it was funny to me because it's called a pistol/revolver permit license, right?
Yeah, okay.
And every single time any officer of the court made reference to this thing, they used a different term.
Really?
They said concealed carry permit, the pistol permit.
Interesting.
Everything concealed, the carry license. Like, they used everything but the term that is the legal terminology here in New Hampshire. Like, these people have no idea what they're talking
about.
You're talking about the machine being well oiled, and I'm like, look, it's definitely greasy. That's about the best we can say about it.
Well, you couldn't grease anybody's palms to make this one work. They denied your request. What did you have to file with this paperwork? Is there a fee?
$10. Yeah, and I think you only pay it if it's granted. So I didn't have to pay up front. Uh-huh. It's just when you come back and you've been approved, you pay the $10.
Then they hand you some sort of piece of paper.
Yeah, it's a lovely piece of paper from what I understand. I don't think they put your picture on it or anything. But
if
you pay extra money, like in Philadelphia, you could pay extra money and get a plastic ID and it has your picture on it. And it's kind of nice. That's what I'd prefer.
Chris Cantwell appears to have one of these things. Apparently, Chris Cantwell, who writes blogs at ChristopherCantwell.com, many of which have been fairly controversial regarding the police and possible violence against the police. Apparently, Chris Cantwell is entirely acceptable. What's the word that they use in the statute?
Suitable person.
Chris Cantwell, a suitable person who has admitted to drug dealing and spending time in jail for it. Not that I have a problem with drug dealing.
No, of course, I understand.
Just comparing and contrasting.
interesting to what was said in court today about you, Derrick J, that you were unsuitable because you were laughing in court.
Yeah. Right. Yeah, that's actually, that was said. And that shocked me. I started thinking, like, am I dreaming? Am I in a Kafka novel? This is too bizarre.
That's so
that they
crazy.
Would use the fact that I was smiling and laughing as an argument for why I shouldn't have a gun. Or not have a gun, just to be clear. The state and the prosecutor admitted that I am lawful to own and possess and openly carry a gun. It's just the concealing part that I shouldn't be allowed to do because I laugh and smile.
As far as New Hampshire law is concerned, Derrick could walk around with a fully automatic rifle slung over his back.
That's
right. There's no New Hampshire law against full auto. There's federal laws that would sort of preempt you from getting one without some hoop jumping.
Okay.
But you could walk around. We were joking around when they first did this. I had the Sega 12 in the house. I was like, we should just have him troop around Central Square with the.
It's a big scary gun.
Yeah, it's a big scary gun. It's a 12-gauge AK-47, which is now like the importation of new
that
ones has actually
crazy.
Been banned by executive order now. But we were like, we should just go have them walk around. And I was like, but then I was like, I don't know, because someone might like take it from them. I didn't want to like be in that position. But the
I said no because it's just not me. Like, yeah, I don't want to open carry. I know I can, and I actually did. When I moved to New Hampshire in 2011 as part of the Free State Project, I brought my gun with me from Pennsylvania, and I openly carried it because I was like, this is great. I couldn't do this in Philadelphia, and I feel so much safer. I'm exercising my rights, and that was exciting. But after a while, I was just like, hey, this is sort of inconvenient. This might snag on something. It scares some people. I'd rather conceal it. I'd rather still be able to keep myself safe, but not be so open about it. You know, I know there are some people who go the other way and say, oh, I want to make a statement and be public about my firearms rights.
They denied you originally back in, was it 2011 or 2012 when you first?
That was 2012.
2012. Must
have
been the beginning of 2012. You applied back then. They denied you for, what was the reason? That you were a known drug user or something like that?
Yeah. I believe that. Well, no, actually. The
pending charges, I believe, at the time.
Right.
Correct.
The initial reason was pending charges. When I went to the police department to further inquire, one of the officers just speculated off the top of his head.
Was that Jason Short who did?
Yes, it was Jason Short.
He reappeared today in court.
Well, that's because he had arrested me for possession of marijuana. So I think he just presumed that, oh, it's that marijuana charge.
I see.
But he was wrong.
So you left town after the victimless crime spree, which people can go to victimlesscrimespree.com and you can check that movie out. Great movie, by the way, to show the family during a Thanksgiving holiday, in my opinion. But after that, you left town.
Yes.
And so you didn't really take that issue further. You didn't appeal it at that time.
And I could have applied for a concealed carry license in Philadelphia. As I mentioned, it's like $10-$25 or something. And it's a May issue state. I'm sure I would have had no problem acquiring it. And then it's reciprocal here in New Hampshire. So I wouldn't even have to
respect it.
Yeah, I wouldn't even have to ask permission of the chief of police here in Keene. I would just ask the chief of police in Philadelphia. And as long as he says it's okay, then it's okay in all of New Hampshire.
They might have potentially jammed you up on some residency stuff after some period of time. Potentially, if you're trying to use a non-resident or a resident permit from another place, then you become a New Hampshire resident. I think they want you to update that after some period of time.
So we'll come back with more here in moments. Whether or not you would want to become a resident is another question. Daryl found that out the hard way. They've gone after us and tried to force us into residency, but it took them several years to come after me for that. There's more coming up here. 855-450-FREE. We'll talk about what happened in court because it was pretty ridiculous. It's Free Talk Live.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw of free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states, "It's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel." Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You dial in toll-free to bring up whatever you'd like. The number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And, of course, we mentioned before, Derrick, Jay, you mentioned that we're here as part of, or not, I guess you and I are here, not Chris Cantwell, but we're here as part of the Free State Project. And the idea, of course, to move as many liberty-loving people as possible to New Hampshire, whether or not they're participants in the Free State Project, I really don't care about. That's one of the reasons why the Shire Society exists. And Chris Cantwell, you are a member of the Shire Society.
Yeah.
And the Shire Society is kind of a similar idea to the Free State Project. The idea behind the Shire Society is that everybody's welcome, not just people who don't live in New Hampshire. People who are from New Hampshire and who've lived in New Hampshire their whole lives, they can join the Shire Society. People all around the globe can join the Shire Society. It's a personal declaration of independence. And there's also the idea of, hey, let's move these people together. Let's get physically together in the same place so we can have more of an effect. And boy, you want to talk about having an effect. Just as an example, so we're in court today for your hearing, Derrick J.
Mm-hmm.
And it's gotten to the point where if there are enough of us in the courtroom, it doesn't really seem to, I don't know what, like, if there's a certain ratio as far as activists to average people, because there were a lot of average people in the courtroom the beginning of the morning before your hearing, Derrick J. Most of them cleared out. There were maybe a couple still remaining. If there are enough liberty activists in the courtroom, when the judge comes in, they will not say all rise. The bailiffs will not say it.
the judge just walks in like it's nothing else. Yeah. Sometimes they'll say court is in session.
Yep.
But that's it.
Judge Burke said, please be seated. And no one was standing.
Only Jean Killam, the prosecutor. Right. She was the only person in court who bothered to stand when Judge Burke first came in to the hearing today. And I wonder if even Jason Short or the other cops stood up.
No, they didn't.
I don't think they did. I only noticed Gene. Maybe they were out of the room or something. I'll have to review the footage and see what happened. But that's one example of where numbers make a huge difference. We've been in this courtroom, Keene District Court, so many times refusing to stand up. They would rather not call attention to it.
Right.
They know there are other people in that courtroom. First of all, if it's just us, they don't bother. But if there's other people in the room, it seems like they're not bothering saying all rise either, because they know if they say all rise,
they don't want to get shown up.
Right. That we're not going to stand for the judge. And those other people in there, they're going to look around. They're going to see that. And I've seen it happen before where average folks in court, if they're surrounded by enough people who are not rising when the bailiffs say all rise, they too will stay seated.
Yeah.
So it's all a numbers game. Anyway, I just thought that was worth pointing out. One of the neat things that happened in court that didn't have anything to do with testifying or what was happening on the stand today.
Yeah, I like that it takes part of the magic out of it when the judge walks in the room. You know, everyone's supposed to rise, and that's like sort of a religious ceremony.
It's totally. You're in pews. I mean, what could be more religious?
Oh, the all only kneel.
Yeah. I mean, the only thing they're missing is, you know, the wine and the bread and, you know, the hymn books in the front of the backside of the pews. I mean,
kneel really, before Zod.
That's it. Hey, by the way, if you want to get a free pound of some of the best coffee out there, go to coffee.freetalklive.com. You get 100% organic, top 1% grade, shade-grown coffee from BuzzBox. It's great coffee, and it's competitively priced with other high-end coffees. But at BuzzBox, we've teamed up with them and Kiva.org to help change people's lives by offering people in poverty an opportunity to make their life better through microloans. So not only do you get great coffee, but you can also help somebody make a better life. And every 10 Free Talk Live listeners that signs up at coffee.freetalklive.com, you can help us fund a new microloan that goes out. And once that gets paid off, we'll loan that money out again. So go to coffee.freetalklive.com. You just pay the shipping cost. You get that free pound. And then you're on their auto ship program. So they'll send you more coffee over time. And you can adjust the how often they send it and how much they're sending. And again, just go to coffee.freetalklive.com to get started. We'll talk more about what happened in court today. Derrick J. hearing for your gun rights, trying to get them respected. The Keene police are not interested in that. We'll go to Rich first, though, in Montana. Rich, you're on Free Talk Live.
First of all the judges are missing is a scepter and crown. I think that would look really good.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, your first mistake was even going for a concealed carry permit. Why do you want to do that?
I wanted to do that so that it would be reciprocal in my home city of Philadelphia.
I mean, if you're going to carry a concealed, what do you really care?
Well, I don't want to go to jail for exercising my rights.
The only way you're going to go to jail,
go ahead, man.
Pardon me?
Go ahead.
The only way you're possibly going to go to jail is if you get caught.
Right.
See, I come from the school of thought that you have the Second Amendment in this country. The Second Amendment is pretty easy to understand.
Yeah, I hear you, man. I mean,
sure,
I agree.
Telling that to the cop putting handcuffs on you. I mean, what is it? What happens in Philadelphia or Pennsylvania in general? I mean, it may be more strict in Philly. What happens if, you know, let's say you're lifting up your shirt, it's cold out, you've got a hoodie, you've got a cop block hoodie on right now,
mm-hmm.
You're going down to Philly tonight. If you were concealing a weapon, you were taking your hoodie off, somebody spots the piece or something, like, you know, it slips and somebody sees it, they call the cops, and then you got an investigation, and who knows what they're going to do. I mean, what happens to you if they bust you?
I live in Montana, okay, and guns are pretty prevalent out here, and most people carry them, and it's just, Nobody really cares. I mean,
sure, I'm with you. And I think that's how it is in New Hampshire to a great extent. I mean, New Hampshire is one of the more freedom friendly gun places, unless you're Derrick J. It's supposed to be pretty easy to get a concealed permit here. And, you know, I'm also of the mindset of, hey, better to ask forgiveness than permission. But when you're dealing with the state, usually the whole asking forgiveness part doesn't go over very well, because their attitude is the law is the law and we'll enforce the law and you're bad. And so you're guilty. And I imagine it's probably a lot worse to get caught with a gun without a permit in Pennsylvania.
Yeah, people get shot
in New Hampshire.
And die. Yeah, people, the police completely overreact. You know, I understand you're in Montana and people are used to seeing guns. Well, in Philly, they're not. And when the police see a regular submittison with a gun, they shoot them.
I want you to come back, Derrick J. When you
the other thing to that is that even in New Hampshire, I mean, we are not your average citizen, right? I mean, we come into contact with law enforcement on a semi-regular basis.
That's
These people are very aware of who we are. So if we are not in compliance with their laws, you know, it's very likely that we're going to get caught. So it's in our best interest generally to avoid breaking them wherever practical.
Well, I mean, there's nothing wrong with it.
I don't think Pennsylvania is a May issue state. Well, the difference between a May issue and a shall issue, on a shall issue state, basically you got to meet three criteria. Okay, you're not a convicted felon. If you were in the military, you have to have been honorably discharged, and you have to be a U.S. citizen. Not that that's going to matter anymore nowadays.
Well, in New Hampshire, they have a situation that they call a suitable person, and
which is like a loophole,
right? Exactly. So it's a shall issue state, but they've got this thing of suitable person, and it's not really well defined. So they have a lot of leeway apparently in that.
The Keene police have defined it as, if we don't like you, we're going to deny you.
Exactly.
Right. They call it something else, but it's a May issue state. In a May issue state, the sheriff can say he doesn't like the color of your eyes, and that could be reason to reject you.
Well, we'll see what the court says in this case. Thank you, Rich, for your call tonight. I do appreciate the idea of, hey, it's my right. I should be able to exercise my rights. And there's nothing wrong with that if that's what your intention is your intention is to do civil disobedience. You should understand what the consequences are going to be. And in places like Philadelphia, I imagine the consequences are pretty high, as Derrick J. suggested. Could be. You'll get shot to death by the police there. So to me, that's not worth that risk. It's not worth making that stand in that place. More coming up. It's Free Talk Live.
With autumn in the air, it's time to think about getting ready for winter. And it's time to save at herbalhealer.com. You'll find amazing seasonal savings to prepare you for the fight against cold and flu season. Like oregacillin to promote lung health. 30 capsules, regularly $34.95, now only $25. HHA olive leaf, the natural antiviral, normally $16.95, now 60 capsules are just $12. HHA elderberry power, a great flu and virus fighter, regularly $16.95, 60 capsules, now $10. Save on all our homeopathic detoxes. Choose from lungs, kidney, liver, brain, libido, or whole body, normally $26.95, now just $20. Visit herbalhealer.com and click on the Fall Winter Specials button to save on all our natural cold and flu fighting products. Also, explore our Herbal Healer Academy correspondence courses that teach you how to handle your health naturally. HerbalHealer.com, healing the world with nature, one person at a time, since 1988.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The Listen Lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You're invited here to take control of the airwaves. You could talk about gun rights or your right to bear arms, whatever kind of arms, because, you know, if you want to carry around a samurai sword in New Hampshire, you can do that too. Strap a sword to your back, that's totally illegal. That's probably something that'll also get you shot in Philly. So we're talking about...
Get you shot in New York, question about
some
that.
Some of the differences between, you know, different jurisdictions, and Derrick J. was in court today. We haven't really even gotten into the details yet on some of the just insane, crazy, funny stuff that that happened there. I want to continue with that discussion. Of course, you can bring up anything you want. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've got Skype as well. Skype username is lrn.fm. ISIS crisis or more hype? Antiwar.com has the answers, the facts, and the readership. What Antiwar.com doesn't have is a pot of gold. The war machine has the magic of the Federal Reserve's printing press and the mainstream media on their side, and all antiwar.com has is you. Their staff is down to a skeleton crew with minimal pay. They're committed to keeping the website online with the best of the worst of all the bad news, but they can't do it for free, and they can't do it without you. They need your donation, so please go to antiwar.com and donate. Again, antiwar.com/donate actually will take you right to the best place to go. And they do, by the way, take Bitcoin proudly and gladly taking Bitcoin. Antiwar.com/donate because war is the health of the state. Ian, Derrick J. and Chris Cantwell in here tonight. We've been talking about your experience this morning as you finally got a hearing. It's been a long time coming since you applied for a gun permit, a concealed permit.
That's because license. The court initially made a mistake and forgot to set a court date. And then after they finally did, they realized that they were breaking their own rules by making it take too long, the remedy for which was to wait longer. So we finally got the court date today in the hearing, and I think my attorney did an amazing job.
Agreed.
Who is your attorney?
Making the case, Evan Knappen. He is a heroic attorney, in my opinion, defending some of the people who need help the most. Firearms legislation can be really confusing, and Evan literally wrote the book on New Hampshire gun laws. You can look up his books. It also includes the federal laws and for New Jersey as well. He operates both, has passed the bar in both states and can defend people there.
There's a really serious task doing that in Jersey.
Huge. And he's defending a woman right now from my home city of Philadelphia, Shaheen Allen, who needs a lot of support and help because she, as a legal concealed carry owner, she has the license, had a handgun and some hollow point bullets that she was traveling with through New Jersey for a party for her son. Cop pulls her over because she was swerving. She's mishonest and says, oh, yeah, I've got a gun in my glove box.
No.
And the cop says, oh, let me take a look at that. So finds out that the gun is illegal, the bullets are illegal, the driving with it is illegal. She's facing multiple felonies just for being honest to the cop. I mean, she's no danger. She's a mother of three, just going to a birthday party. But the cop didn't have the, I mean, they have something called discretion where they could be like, you know, miss, I'm going to pretend I didn't see that.
Certainly could.
Yeah, maybe go ahead and put that thing in the trunk. I mean, there's a federal law that protects you if you're traveling between states. If you're legal to have the gun where you're coming from and where you're going, you're protected by federal law if you have the gun. I believe you have to have them in separate locked boxes and, like, in the trunk of the car. I might be going a little overboard with it, but the idea being, you know, you have to make that gun as inaccessible as possible. Okay. And then, you know, because if I were to travel through Massachusetts, right, I've got a 38 caliber revolver loaded on my hip right now. If I just accidentally cross the border into Massachusetts, I'm going to prison, right? Like, you can't, you cannot do that. But if I'm on my way to Philadelphia or something like that, and I cross through Massachusetts, if my gun is in the trunk in a lockbox with the ammo in a separate lockbox, the Massachusetts police might want to arrest me, but then they'll be prosecuted under federal law for violating my right to transport a firearm.
Share your thoughts with us here, your experiences with guns and the government. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So, Derrick J., they denied your request for this license to carry concealed. Because, again, you can open carry here in New Hampshire, no problem. That's legal. In fact, they even acknowledged that in court. Like, oh, yeah, you've got the right to carry this openly, and that's fine. But because you want to conceal and because you were laughing in court, and because also you've been arrested in the past, not for anything violent, but because you've been arrested, and resisting arrest. I see some resisting arrest charges here, even though it was resisting arrest without violence, which is, of course, you know, different than resisting arrest with violence. Even though there was no evidence presented whatsoever that you were a violent character or a danger to anyone, they said, you know, sorry, you can't have this. And that was essentially their argument in court.
That's right. Today. And the prosecutor even used the word violent during her closing speech. I forget what they're called in court, but she made a closing speech and the prosecutor gets to speak last.
Uh-huh.
And you can't object or say anything. So, you know, of course, she just throws in her, oh, and he's violent. Yeah. He doesn't
you
have any respect for the court.
She knew better than to say that, you know, when there was a chance for rebuttal. She saved that for the very last second so that she would be in the, you know, so that nobody could rebut it. Because she knows. I mean, and she looked ridiculous the entire day today, too, by the way. I mean, she looks ridiculous in general. She's just a tall, ridiculous-looking woman.
She's an Amazon
The
woman,
Amazon prosecutor.
Her. Yeah. Her name is Killam, which I think is an entirely appropriate last name for somebody whose job it is to stamp out the activist scourge here in Keene.
Just like come in here and lock everybody up. I mean, kill them. I mean, lock them up.
I try and connect with all of the bureaucrats and local authorities. Like, I was really trying to make eye contact with Ken Miola. He's the chief of police here who denied me. He wouldn't do it. And
really?
It was sort of fun because I got to play this little game where he was hiding behind a bailiff. And I was, you know, moving my chair over to the left a little bit to like, oh, let me make eye contact with Ken. No, he would scoot over, and we were playing a little back and forth game of like hide from the eye contact. It was really weird. I mean, like, what kind of adult plays games like this?
Well, this is the same guy who there's video footage of him where I approach him at one of the cop day things. They have like a national night out, I think they call it. It happens every 2 years here in Keene. I don't know if it's every 2 years everywhere, but it's where the cops bring out the Bearcat, they bring out the armored truck, and they, you know, bring out the fingerprinting kit. And
look,
you know,
at all the cool stuff we're going to use to kill you if you ever screw with us.
They totally show off their boys with their toys, and they'll do tours of the police department, and they've got, you know, the cops are out there grilling hot dogs and hamburgers. And so one day I'm there, I got my video camera, of course, and I see
you guys want a hot dog, you paid for it, huh?
I see the police chief there who you're describing not making eye contact with you, and I knew he was not talking to me and not making eye contact with me. And it's so it's not just you, it's also me and Dave Ridley, who calls this show sometimes from ridleyreport.com. So I, you know, come up to him with the video camera to see how he'll behave on camera, and he again pretends like I don't exist, as though I'm like some sort of ghost, like I'm a non-entity in his world. And it's such a bizarre video because for like 2 minutes straight, I'm following him around trying to get him to talk, you know, speak to me. And all the while, he's acknowledging everyone else that comes by him. Like, yeah, he'll talk to a little kid or an old man and, like, you know, it's being very, very friendly as though he's just, you know, Mr. Friendly Police Chief. And here's this independent journalist trying to get him to, you know, answer a question. And he's just pretending I don't exist. It's crazy.
Yeah,
it's
if only so you would disappear.
And we get accused of being the childish ones. One of the common accusations thrown at the liberty activists here in Keene by people who dislike our activism is that you're so childish. But yeah. Wait a minute, this guy wouldn't even look at us, let alone talk to us.
That and neckbeard.
That
no matter,
one too, yeah.
No matter how well shaved you are,
which
you're always a neckbeard.
The guy, one of the guys who accused us of being a neckbeard, I went on his Facebook profile, and there's plenty of pictures with him unshaven.
Yeah.
You know? Well, speaking of Ken Miola and his decision, when he took the stand today, one of the things he said was that he had denied me, and yada yada, for whatever reason. My attorney jumped on that, like, mm-hmm. Oh yeah, what? Tell me what for whatever reason means.
If I could just elaborate on that, right? So what? Because I think this is an important point that you're about to make here. So the chief is going on about the various charges that Derrick had collected over a period of time, right? Mm-hmm. And he's talking about resisting arrest and filming and whatever it was that he got caught for. And he said at the end of it, he said, albeit for whatever reason. And so as Derrick was saying, the attorney had jumped on that when he cross-examined him, and we'll talk about that more when we come back.
We will come back with more. 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about, but it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it, but here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
The experts at Web.com want to build your business a successful website for free, just like we did for these current Web.com customers.
We've used and looked at other website designers, but there's nobody better than Web.com.
Web.com can build your website in as little as 7 days free. Plus, we'll promote it on all the major search engines like Google, Yahoo, and Bing. If after 30 days you're happy, we'll continue to provide promotion, hosting, support, and maintenance, all for one low monthly fee. If not, cancel and pay nothing.
If you're in business today and you don't have a web presence, you won't be taken seriously.
Call right now and you'll also get a free .com or .net domain name for your new website powered by VeriSign, the world's leading domain name provider.
Call 800-297-0154. That's 800-297-0154.
No upfront charge for site build, after which ongoing fees apply. Rights to site are relinquished when canceled. Domain included during active service, after which fees apply.
That's 800-297-0154.
When you're coping with bad news and the news media come calling, and they will, don't clam up. As notorious political figures find out the hard way, the cover-up can be worse than the crime. So get out in front of unfavorable news about your company, your group, or organization, or yourself. The sooner you confront a negative story, the sooner it will be over. Responding as quickly to negative stories as you do to positive ones enhances your credibility. Hiding embarrassing information or lying will do more damage than damage control. Never stonewall. Tell your side of the story, use specifics, and detail what corrective action has already been taken. Respond in kind. If the issue is emotional, don't sound like a cold, unemotional Mr. Spock. For more tips on critical communication skills for the way things are now, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting block and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You don't have rights unless you exercise them. And that's what Derrick J has been trying to do with his supposed right to bear arms. But of course, if you have to ask permission to exercise a right, then your right doesn't actually exist. You've got a privilege. And you attempted to apply for this concealed carry license, as they call it here in New Hampshire, but the government goons in the Keene Police Department decided you are not a suitable person. There's this loophole word of suitable in the statute that generally reads fairly good. It's supposed to be a shall issue state, which means that unless you're some sort of crazy killer and or a felon, they're supposed to issue this thing. But Keene Police saw fit to not issue it to you, and that was what brought you to court today. We'll continue with some of the other courtroom shenanigans that went on, but we'll also go to your calls and thoughts. Plus, join us online at freetalklive.com. And hey, if you like what we're doing here on Free Talk Live, then please shop with us. Go to shop.freetalklive.com. You can enter Amazon through the links you'll find at shop.freetalklive.com, and Free Talk Live will get a cut of the purchase price. So whatever it is you need to buy, again, you can probably find it at shop.freetalklive.com, and Free Talk Live will get a cut even during, you know, Black Friday sales and Cyber Monday. And of course, now the new thing with Black Friday is to have Black Friday week, where, you know, probably makes it so people don't come in all on one day. I think that's probably a good idea. And you're seeing the brick and mortar companies doing that, and you're seeing Amazon do that as well. So if you're looking to do some holiday shopping this weekend or tonight, go to shop.freetalklive.com and start there as we go with your calls and thoughts. Rich is listening in Raleigh to Talk Radio 850. Hey, Rich.
Good evening, gentlemen. How are you?
Welcome, sir. You're on the air.
Thank you. I just wanted to, I didn't buy weapons for a long time. I now own a couple of handguns and a rifle. And I had been in the military, and for many years, I had struggled with some depression issues and was kind of afraid of having weapons in the house. But when the current occupant of the White House, came in 2008, I kind of suspected that there was a chance that there was going to be an attempt to do a grab, or at least basically cut off access to all types of handguns and rifles and so on. Now, I just kind of be interested in hearing you discuss some of your feelings about the Second Amendment in general philosophically, and wanted to share what I thought was a very good presentation by a guy by the name of Bill Whittle. Do you listen to Bill Whittle?
Yeah, I'm familiar. Oh, he does great work.
All right.
Yeah, journalist with Pajama Media, I think.
Right. He does wonderful work. And he has a segment on what he calls the firewall called Your Second Amendment. And he talks about having a linguistic expert parse the text of the Second Amendment and say, you know, is there any restriction? In other words, why would anybody think that there's a restriction, you know, with respect to a right that is clearly stated and shall not be abridged? So, you know, if you want to pick this up and run with it, that's fine.
What I would say to that is, you know, even amongst like strict constructionists on the Constitution, you'll see some difference of opinion on what the Second Amendment means, right? I mean, you'll see people that say that like the incorporation doctrine of the 14th Amendment is illegitimate, right? That the federal government can't force gun freedom on state governments. And then other people feel like the 14th Amendment, if not the Second Amendment itself, prevents state governments from infringing upon your, you know, quote, right to keep and bear arms. Me personally, I don't think that the Constitution has been so terribly useful in protecting freedom, right?
Not at all. There's no evidence for that.
Every last promise that the Constitution ever made was broken. And as Lysander Spooner said, whether the Constitution be one thing or whether it be another, what's certain is that it is either allowed such a government, permitted such a government as we have had, or been powerless to prevent it. In either case, it's unfit to exist. So I don't personally put a lot of stock in the Second Amendment, but I do put a lot of stock in just the general idea of self-defense. I mean, self-defense has been recognized through common law well before there was a United States, before the continent had even been discovered, quote unquote. And so I would say that the issue at hand here is just this natural prerogative to defend oneself, and that the state would seek to prevent people from doing that in any way just goes to point out that they have ill intentions, that they are not out here trying to do good things, whatever their claims.
Well, I would agree with that, but you said something about the right to self-defense existing in common law. Well, the whole point of this is the Constitution is based on common law. Right? I mean, you know, the Constitution itself is based on common law, and the first 10 amendments are supposed to be what the government can't do to you.
Well,
right?
But the idea would generally be like, you know, if you had a common law in the sense of property rights, if you had a common law in terms of, you know, property, you wouldn't have a constitution, right? You wouldn't have a federal government. You wouldn't have an income tax. There wouldn't need to be a Second Amendment because the government would have no power to take your guns in the first place. The entire idea of the Constitution, and I mean, if you look at the Federalist and the Anti-Federalist Papers, I mean, you can see pretty easily that the Anti-Federalists had it right. You know, if you look at the Federalist Papers, John Adams and Alexander Hamilton are telling us that, hey, this is all fine and good, and we're not going to do anything bad to you. And Thomas Jefferson and his crew are saying, no, these guys are up to no good. They're going to do terrible things. This is a takeover. This is a new government. And so the promises that were made, every single one of them were broken. So we can see very clearly, and that's why they went for a Bill of Rights in the first place, that they said, hey, we need new restrictions on this government because it's claiming all sorts of new authority. And they put these amendments in there, which never should have been needed because, according to the Federalists, these powers didn't exist in the begin with. When the Bill of Rights was put there, those were like the lifeboats, right? Like the first 10 amendments to the Constitution. You know, we have our main ship, which is the Constitution, which is supposed to prevent the government from even having any authority to do any of these things. And then we have the lifeboats, which is the first 10 amendments. Mm. Now we're beyond the lifeboats now, that the federal government is actually restricting our right to keep and bear arms.
And
it's violating
all the other rights in
exactly,
the Constitution.
Every single portion of it. And now we're to a point where we're not even in the lifeboats anymore. We're clinging to pieces of the ship in the
You're
water,
the
and we're threatening to drown, and we're in serious trouble. So I think that if we're looking to the Constitution, whether it's the Second Amendment or the 10th Amendment or the 18 enumerated powers, we're in really sad shape, folks, if we think that this document that's hundreds of years old, written by a bunch of dead slave-owning, mostly Christians, is not going to do a whole lot to help us out in modern-day America.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah, but that's the argument you're using, is they're dead, you know, slave-holding. You just use the liberal argument to invalidate the Constitution.
Well, no,
the Constitution's been invalidated, man. Hey, Rich, I don't know if you've been paying attention, but the Constitution's been invalidated by the fact that all 10, you know, amendments essentially have been crapped on by the federal government and the various different state governments.
They've been invalidated by progressives.
No, they've been invalidated by conservatives and everybody else. The idea here being, Rich, my point is the reason that I referred to the bunch of dead, you know, dead slave-owning Christians, I mean, this is a religious doctrine. Do you understand that this is an ancient document written by a bunch of guys who aren't around anymore? We might as well be talking about the Bible, and I don't think that that's a sound idea to be as used as an excuse for violence in society.
That's exactly the argument that liberals and progressives use.
Believe me, Rich, I spend more time bashing liberals than you spend at work, okay? I hate the left more than anybody in New Hampshire, or I am the anti-left, believe me when I tell you. But just because liberals every once in a while utter a truth, don't pin me as some kind of guy who's left of Karl Marx, because I don't believe that the Constitution is doing a damn thing for us, because it's not.
I'm not, but the point is that then you need to come up with some kind of supportable intellectual framework other than just saying, you know, that the Constitution isn't doing it.
Well, I do, but I can't spell out the entire construct of human society in every 15-minute reg media segment that we do between commercials. I can tell you all about dispute resolution agencies and how markets solve problems better than governments. I'm just right now telling you about a problem.
Well, you know, the Constitution, it's a goner, dude. And you can hear the sort of the religious fervor, right? The idea that we would dare attack the Constitution. We must not, or we must be on the left. I don't consider myself left or right, personally, or center. I'm a liberty-minded person. I care about freedom every issue, every time. And if the conservatives or the Republicans who've been in office gave a damn about rights, then they could have done something when they had total control of the House and the Senate and the presidency for, what was it, 6 years, 2000 to 2006, and they didn't do a damn thing to protect anybody's rights. I thank you, Rich, for the call, and, you know, neither did the Democrats. They've just all been building on one another, taking power year after year, or, you know, assuming more power, I guess. Hour number two is coming up. This is Free Talk Live.
Kay Oliver is part of the Tweyambe Women's Group in Jinja, Uganda. She gets old clothes, fixes them up, washes them, and then sells them at the Jinja market. She was quite happy with her success at her business, but realized that a sewing machine would really help her make more money to take care of her two kids. Free Talk Live helped her get that sewing machine. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound, try out the subscription, cancel at any time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Boost Kit Essentials Nutritionally Complete Drink, providing your picky eater with essential nutrition and great taste in one drink. Visit us at kitessentials.com. To make sure your kids eat healthy, follow the 5-a-day plan. Serve 3 servings of vegetables and 2 servings of fruit daily. Remember, a serving could just mean a piece of fruit or a half cup of veggies. If your kids are picky eaters, ask a nutritionist about other sources. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
The 3 most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are 1, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. 2, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. 3, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 2 is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Wednesday, November 26, 2014. Gold closed Tuesday at $1,199, up $2. Silver closed at $16.65, up 13 cents. And Bitcoin is trading around $375.77. Today's Bitcoin price is brought to you by Express Coin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at expresscoin.com. The Liberty Beat is sponsored in part by Marjorie Wildcraft's Grow Your Own Groceries, homegrown food on every table. That's growyourowngroceries.org. In the news, on Tuesday, Missouri Governor Jay Nixon ordered 1,500 additional National Guard troops into Ferguson. The increase in troops in Ferguson brings the total number of troops to 2,200. That's only 900 less than are stationed in Iraq. Monday and Tuesday nights were marked by clashes with the police and protesters, and isolated looting and rioting. Officials say 21 fires were set and 12 buildings were burned. Early Wednesday, police in Hong Kong began removing protesters from a central demonstration site. Reuters reports that police began erecting metal barricades and dismantling tents used by protesters in the Mong Kok district. Witnesses reported several protesters were dragged away, while others continued to face off with the police. The Obama administration is expected to announce plans to reduce the amount of smog-forming pollution allowed in the air. The Associated Press reports that the Environmental Protection Agency will seek comments on a proposed 60 parts per billion, down from 75 parts per billion enacted by the Bush administration. The regulations would be one of the most expensive ever issued, with estimated costs of $19 billion to $90 billion. Today's edition of the Liberty Beat is made possible by eFoods Direct, redefining the way you think about storable food. They've created a menu of food that's so good, so easy to make, you'll find yourself eating it every day, even though it has a shelf life of up to 25 years. eFoods Direct is offering 10% off to all Liberty Beat listeners. Just go to eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat. Or call 800-620-5520 and mention Liberty Beat for your savings today. Support also comes from The Corey Moore Show. Live every Friday night, liberty-minded, comedy-focused. The Corey Moore Show, Friday nights at 10 o'clock Eastern at CoreyMooreShow.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Wednesday, November 26, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. And like us on Facebook at facebook.com/thelibertybeat. On Tuesday, the Los Angeles City Council voted to start drafting an ordinance that would force residents to lock up their handguns or disable them with trigger locks when not in use. The council voted 11-0 to begin drafting rules, which will be voted on at a later date. City Councilman Paul Krikorian said it is not a right to keep an unlocked and loaded firearm on their bedstand. Three research teams from the universities of Leeds, Bristol, and Oxford have concluded that the use of geoengineering may be necessary to halt climate change, but will not be without consequences. Professor Piers Forster of Leeds University told the BBC that between 1.2 and 4.1 billion people could be adversely affected by changes in rainfall patterns due to geoengineering. The researchers used computer models to simulate possible effects of various geoengineering schemes, including spraying sulfate aerosols into the sky from planes. The teams confirmed that previous reports that show that once a program begins, it must be maintained for years or there would be disastrous damage to the planet. The Liberty Beat would like to thank Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Want to reach tens of thousands of like-minded listeners every day with your message or product? Well, the Liberty Beat is looking for sponsors for their daily news service. Support this grassroots media project while expanding your reach to a targeted market. To get further details, just go online to thelibertybeat.com/advertise. This is the Liberty Beat for Wednesday, November 26, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
A report released Tuesday by physicists at Stanford University revealed that the entire known universe, from the whole of human civilization to the totality of matter and energy, is actually the fictional setting of a cop show called Hard Case. According to authors of the report, existence as we know it was created solely to provide the framework for the primetime drama that airs weekly in a parallel universe, and that every historical event prior to the show's September 2008 pilot, including the Renaissance, World War II, evolution, the September 11th attacks, and the presidential administration, administrations of Washington through Clinton never actually happened and are merely part of the elaborate backstory crafted by Hard Case creator and showrunner Dominic Egan.
We used to believe that our universe operated under immutable laws of thermodynamics and gravitational relativity, but now we know everything just comes from the minds of Hard Case's 12 staff writers. Overall, it seems like a very well-written show.
Physicists have theorized that the universe as we know it will cease to exist whenever Hard Case airs its final episode.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you want. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. It's Thanksgiving Eve, and we are live. We being me, Ian.
And Chris Cantwell.
ChristopherCantwell.com is his website. Chris, what will listeners find when they go to ChristopherCantwell.com? What's the latest there?
The latest there is a collection of racist tweets about the Ferguson demonstrations. And by racist, I mean anti-white and black supremacist sort of tweets that implying that just race pimping crap from Ferguson, basically.
What's the what's your goal with that?
I have said before on this program that I get really angry with how obsessed with race people are in this country. I think that the thing going on in Ferguson, I mean, the first thing that you see in that list of tweets is, well, if you support this grand jury, then you're supporting white supremacy, was the first tweet that I put up there. And I think that that's ridiculous, you know, that a strong-arm robber gets shot in the street, and that I say that the guy who shot the strong-arm robber shouldn't go to prison. That makes me a white supremacist. I think that's really offensive. So I decided
I don't believe you're a white supremacist or anything like that. I mean, you grew up in Long Island. You had friends of all kinds of colors.
Yeah, exactly. I was right around the corner from Brentwood. I would frequently buy drugs in Harlem, and, you know, So it's a ridiculous thing. But I'm just talking about what people were saying about Ferguson. I mean, if you followed the hashtag Ferguson, Ferguson on the night that they announced that there would be no indictment in the case, it was all about race. And the other hashtag that started trending was Black Lives Matter, and telling people, hey, you better realize that Black Lives Matter, black president. I mean, it's like, are you kidding me? There's a black president. He was elected mostly by white people. And you people think that what the whites are just out to get you. I'm like, this is absolutely sickening. There was one tweet that I had. There was a guy said, you know, we're not going to keep on taking this from this system. You hear that, you people in power, a.k.a. white men? And so I tweeted a reply to him as a picture of Barack Obama and Hillary Clinton laughing, you know, because he doesn't seem to be too well informed about who's in power these days. So this is the most recent thing that's up there. I spent most of the day today trying to get money out of my website.
I get the, you know, I guess I can understand the frustration, but it seems like a lot of people have gone down the wrong road. And when you said you people, I don't think you meant black people. You meant the people who were tweeting.
It's
these
mostly
things.
White liberals that I'm actually angry with, right? It's white people who are talking. Like, I saw there's a number of tweets in there that said, you know, look, white people have our concerns too, but, you know, black people are more important right now, is one of the tweets. I was like, are you sick?
How about human beings are just important? What about human lives are important?
Right.
Now, I can understand why people in urban neighborhoods are upset with the police. There's a lot of good reasons they've got to be upset with the police. I mean, it's, you know, they've learned in a lot of places in urban areas to not talk to the police because they know the police are not their friends. They're likely to arrest people who are their family members, you know, arrest their brothers and arrest their sisters and uncles and, you know, all over the place. And so the police have really touched their lives in a real negative fashion. But unfortunately, some people have decided that the solution is to burn down Little Caesars and set Walgreens ablaze. And we could talk more about what happened. I'd like to do that because I don't know if they talked about it last night. Last night was my night off. And looking at the show notes from yesterday, I don't think they broached the subject of Ferguson. So I think
you could have missed that.
I don't
night.
Know
crazy,
either.
Yeah.
I mean, we talked about it the night prior to that, right before, like literally when we finished the show, a few minutes after that is when stuff started going crazy down there. And I was monitoring one of the live feeds for at least a couple of hours. And so I saw some of that stuff happen. Let's go first to your calls and thoughts, though. You can bring up whatever's on your mind. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Let's talk to Pete. He's in California. Pete, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Chris.
Well, I got to say that to that thing about the racism, I want them to read Romans chapter 2, verse 11. It says with the Lord, he doesn't care if you're a Jew, a Greek, slave, or free. It says there's no respect of persons with God. He didn't care what you look like. Either you're saved or you're not saved. These people, it's a spirit of division. It's a demonic spirit that wants to get race baiting and hate, you know, for what it's doing. And it's focusing the, it's one of the dictator's oldest tactics.
Could you tell me, I'm sorry to interrupt you, but could you tell me how you come to the conclusion that a demonic spirit is causing MSNBC to be a bunch of political opportunist race pimps?
Well, you know, that's what they're doing. It's behind it. Even though we can't see it and stuff, look at what, you know.
That didn't answer the question. It never does.
Can you rephrase that for him, Chris? We're not cutting you off. I'm saying you didn't answer the question. We're trying to have a conversation, which requires, you know, one side asking a question and then the other side answering it, at least at this point. Chris, can you rephrase that? Maybe Pete can.
So what you said is that the reason that these race pimps in the media are trying to start a race war in Louisiana is because, or I'm sorry, Missouri?
Missouri, is
because of a demonic spirit. And I'm just interested to know how a demonic spirit entered our rational discussion.
How did it? Because, well, you don't have fear of
because
God, obviously,
Pete
but
from California
being a conservative, being a conservative pastor and stuff, the Bible says that there's things
you're a pastor?
Can't control. You can't say, of course
you're
I am.
A pastor,
right.
So like people actually show up and listen to you talk. Is that what are you trying to
wait
make
a
us
minute.
Believe?
You don't
that?
Have to wait. Wait. Just because you're a pastor doesn't mean somebody's going to listen to show up and listen to you. But
I speak out, you know. If you tickle people's ears, lies and sweet nothings, and tell them health, wealth, prosperity, they'll love you. If you speak out against evil and call this what it is, evil and of the devil, they hate you. They get mad.
Where do you do your preaching, Pete? Pastor Pete, where do you do your preaching?
At the gay pride parade.
I want to see video footage.
I was the only person there. I could swear with the sign.
I want to see video footage. Where do you street preach in California?
Everywhere, the train, anywhere and everywhere I can. And you know what? It makes people mad. I tell the truth. When you preach the gospel the way it is, literal, you know, then people get mad. You say abortion is murder. You say drug abuse is idolatry. You say homosexuality is evil. You preach anything, any conservative Christianity, makes people mad.
How many of those people, by the way, would you like to hang? Idolaters, homosexuals, drug users, should all of them hang? Because you've called previously to say that you think gay people should hang. Should drug users hang?
The hanging thing, people are like, oh, why do you advocate that? Why don't you read Leviticus 20, verse 13?
No, I don't want to. I don't want to read that.
I've been cover to cover through that book.
I want to ask
Pete.
Why
don't you believe it?
Pete, I want to ask you, not some old book. I want to know what you think. Should a drug user be hanged by Pete's morality, by Pete's system?
Are they using it for medicine because they're in pain or they have cancer?
No, they're using it to get high.
Okay, then that means that it's idolatry because it came from the Eastern world to channel demons. That's also
demons.
Why do you think that's funny?
Well, look,
should they be hanged? You still haven't answered the question.
No, they should not be.
Okay, so hang the gays,
they should be hit with a stick, and in open court, they should be given a trial, and then they should be by jury of their peers. If they have done idolatry and smoked drugs and do what they do, they need to be hit with a stick 20
times.
Okay,
so hit the drug users with a stick, but gay people should be hanged. Is that right? Just trying to follow.
It's an abomination.
But look, Pete, haven't you ever read page 40 of Harry Potter before?
You know that's of the devil, and you know what?
Harry Potter's of the devil now. Have you ever seen the 14th episode of Sesame Street? It's from the devil. It's from the devil. Have you ever seen 24? The devil.
Well, actually, you're right, Jim Henson. I talked to one of the. you know what?
Are you for real?
I'm serious. I talked to one of the people that used to do the voice for Bert and Ernie and stuff, and the old days, and he told me that Jim Henson made Bert and Ernie to be together. It has homosexual messages.
You hear, Jim Henson was Satan.
You hear these stories, like, have you ever heard the stories of, like, other talk shows like Mark Levin and stuff? They would, like, pay for fake callers and stuff. I've thought that was the case when I used to listen to Free Talk Live,
but you can't
come up with this stuff. Like, this is a real lunatic from California. This is the only way to explain
it. Hey, Pete, can we find your street preaching online? Is there a YouTube channel?
Well, you know, I'm currently building one, but let me tell you something.
All right, let us know when you get it together. Let us know when you get it together. You don't actually have to build a channel. You just go and sign up for it. You just go and, you know, got a Google account.
And you can even make a few bucks, and, you know, maybe if you get some of them views coming in, you make a few dollars, and then when you go and you street preach, you won't look like a homeless lunatic screaming about the Bible to people on a train.
Here's a special message for those of you who owe the IRS at least $10,000 or more in back taxes. The IRS has special programs in place that could eliminate or reduce your tax debt by thousands of dollars. Call the tax helpline that has been set up to help you. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. Stop the wage garnishments, levies, and tax liens now. Once you've qualified and enrolled, the IRS will stop all the collection activities against you. These unique programs have been allocated to help the economy and significantly reduce or eliminate your tax burden. The IRS is currently accepting reduced settlements and other favorable programs. You may qualify for substantial savings, so get the help you need. For free information and to see if you qualify, take down the number now for the Tax Representation Hotline. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. 800-691-6129.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think you
excuse
are?
Excuse me.
There is no video and audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make it.
Wait,
now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you're scared
of
me!
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up what you'd like. It is the Thanksgiving Eve edition of the show. I should remind you, we will be here live tomorrow night. And as we are on every Thanksgiving and Christmas Eve and Thanksgiving Eve and New Year's Eve, and we're live basically 365 days a year here on Free Talk Live. So if you call in tonight, that's cool. You can bring up anything. Maybe you're busy tonight. You want to call in tomorrow. It really doesn't matter when you want to participate with the show, because we're always here 7 to 10 at night Eastern Time, 7 days a week. Tonight, the we is me, Ian.
And Chris Cantwell.
ChristopherCantwell.com is his website. We're going to your phone calls and thoughts. Coming up, we can talk about Ferguson. There was something else that I thought was neat to highlight about Derrick J's hearing today that we didn't get a chance to do when he was in the studio with us.
Yeah, there was a lot of laughs today in the courtroom, and it is an interesting case that I would have liked to have paid more attention to, so maybe we'll try to come back to that.
There's a lot that we can, of course, talk about. You can bring up anything, and you will do that here in a moment, but first, I want to let you know about the Texas Bitcoin Conference. It's coming up next year. Mark and I were there this year, the very first one that happened earlier this year. Next year, 2015, it's March 28th and 29th. It's going to be in downtown Austin this time. So last time it was just outside of Austin, which, you know, the hotel was nice, but the location was kind of out in the middle of nowhere. This is going to be right in the heart of downtown, the Moody Theater in downtown Austin. So I'm excited about the new location. It's going to be loaded up with the best and the brightest speakers, the latest exhibitions in Bitcoin. They'll also be hosting the second $1 million Bitcoin 2.0 hackathon. Now, in order to sort of cancel out some of the best and the brightest speakers, they've also invited the entire Texas legislature to allow them to see firsthand that not enacting complicated regulations encourages innovation and job creation. The Texas Bitcoin Conference will prove that Bitcoin is a force for good. If you're knee-deep in Bitcoin or just interested, this is going to be the place to be. And if you've never been to a Bitcoin conference before, this is a great one to go to. I thought it was really good last year. March 28th and 29th. And there's also a kickoff event happening on the 27th. If you get into town early, you can go and get registered over at TexasBitcoinConference.com. Grab your tickets there. That's TexasBitcoinConference.com. And Free Talk Live is slated to broadcast live from the event. So we'll look forward to seeing you there. TexasBitcoinConference.com, March 28th and 29th. Let's go to the phones to Jimmy. He's in Arizona and on via Skype. Hello, Jimmy.
How y'all doing?
Hey, Jimmy. Go ahead.
Yeah, I'm sorry. It's been a while since I called y'all. I've been busy.
Sorry, you don't have to apologize. We're here. Go ahead.
Well, I'm the executive producer of a five-minute YouTube video that my wife Milford's making, and it's called The Joy of Breastfeeding Your Pets, and it's it's wonderful. Hey, so I got a problem, as usual, you know. Me and Pugnacious Pete.
You mean the guy who just called in from California, the super religious street preacher?
Yeah, yeah. Well, he's a great, has a wonderful personality. The
homeless lunatic who yells at people on the train.
Yeah, well, me, Pugnacious Pete, and James from Arizona, we're going on a nationwide nut-kicking tour, and yeah, laugh at it, Christopher Cantwell.
A nut-kicking tour.
Yeah, yeah, we want to kick just nuts, you know, and spread the word of Jesus about peace and love while kicking people in between their legs.
Is that because people are likely to call out for Jesus if they get kicked in the nuts?
Yes, we want to make sure that they're calling out for Jesus no matter what we're doing to them, kicking them, punching
them. I'm very concerned about the misandry here, okay? Because it seems to me that you are targeting men, sir, and to target people because of their gender just seems so inappropriate.
Oh, no, we'll kick women, we'll kick transgenders, we'll kick animals. It doesn't matter. We don't discriminate.
Now, we heard earlier
you're
going to
breastfeed your pets and then you're going to kick them?
Well, I can't breastfeed. I've tried. It's difficult. But James is
leaving
really
that
good
to Milford. Now, look, we had Pete on a moment ago, and he said he was trying to build a YouTube channel. Apparently, he needs some help with this. Apparently, sounds like your wife, Milford, she's got that down, so maybe you could help him out, and while you're doing the nut-kicking tour, you could kind of help him make a YouTube channel so he can put some of his street preaching online.
Yeah, and this is scary, because we bought us one of them VW vans, you know, to go on our tour with.
Yeah.
Now, As y'all might know, Christopher Cantwell posted a bunch of pictures of himself nude on the internet.
And, there was only one that I know of, at least, Chris. Was
there I'm sure there's a few Photoshops now.
Pete has that picture posted up in the van. I don't know why, you know. It's weird.
It's to remember the demons. The demons are always around you.
Demonic spirits between
and I've caught
my
James,
thighs.
I've caught James staring at me awkwardly. And it's starting to get uncomfortable. And
does he look like he's mentally undressing you?
Well, salivating and mentally undressing. And laugh it up, boys. I'll tell you what, we're bringing the nut kicking tour there.
All right, brother. Thanks for the call, Jimmy. Appreciate it. 855-450-FREE.
Yeah, give us a call. You can talk about kicking people in the nuts for Jesus.
I think Dave in New York is going to feel left out. Dave, tell me. You are upset because you are not going to be part of this nut-kicking tour. I mean, Pugnacious Pete, Jimmy from Arizona, James from Arizona, they're all getting together. They left you out, buddy.
No, I really don't care about what your previous callers had to say. First of all, I want to wish you guys a happy Thanksgiving. I don't know if
you guys are
on the air tomorrow night. I don't know if you guys will be on the air tomorrow night.
We will really be, actually. We'll be live.
My friend Nickelhood called in last week about me, and I want to rebuttal about it.
Okay, this is the guy who, for listeners who are new to the show, Dave in New York has been calling for quite a while, and Nick, this guy called in from, I think it was Boston, saying that he's been sort of following your exploits, Dave, online since about a decade ago, 8 years or something like that, and that he found you originally on a Howard Stern message board. And that ever since then, he's been sort of following where you go and watching you stir up trouble on various different forums and then complaining when trouble comes your way because, you know, you tend to be upset about how people treat you online. But yet, when anybody goes and actually observes how you behave, Dave, that you do not behave well towards others online. And so it's not a surprise that people also treat you poorly in response. So go ahead. That was kind of the summary of what Nick's call was previously. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Yeah, I want to rebuttal. First of all, I do not live in a battered women's shelter at all. No, I do not, because she had mentioned that, and I just want to pointedly clear that out. I do not live
in a battered
women's shelter.
Did you live
in
a battered women's shelter at some point?
Are you a battered woman?
No, I did not. I never did.
I thought you said that on one of your videos. Maybe I misheard it.
And second of all, he said something mentioning about that. That's hard for me to make friends. I have plenty of friends, including Nick from Boston. He is my best friend.
Why would your best friend come on national radio and basically indict you as a welfare, sort of a welfare whore?
Because it's hysterical, I think. That's probably, that would be the explanation for it.
I don't know if that's something that a friend would do.
I have never been on welfare. Never been on welfare.
Didn't he allege you were on welfare? Didn't he say you were on welfare?
Were you ever abused by a woman?
No, I was never. I have never been abused by a woman.
Because I mean, it happens all the time.
I've been abused by a woman.
Yeah, I've been abused by women my entire life.
You're lucky, Dave.
Maybe you're a lucky guy.
Your mom didn't spank you.
No, she never did. Never did. I've always been the most perfect child ever.
You are adorable. Thanks, Dave, for the call tonight.
Such a good boy, Dave, in New York.
855-450-FREE.
Never incurred mommy's wrath.
855-450-3733. We've got time for you. And we've almost checked all of the regular trolls off the list here tonight.
We need some new trolls.
More
call in.
It's Free Talk Live.
Are you ready to surrender your right to buy body armor? No joke. Congress is now trying to outlaw civilian body armor. And if House Bill H.R. 5344 becomes law, you can kiss your right to protect yourself against rifle bullets goodbye. Don't put off your body armor purchase any longer. Go now to InfidelBodyArmor.com. Thousands of military veterans trust their lives to Infidel Body Armor. You should too. Spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
Hi, I'm Sam Nussbaum, WellPoint's Chief Medical Officer. We proudly support the March of Dimes mission to improve the health of babies and fight premature birth. We're helping the March of Dimes fund breakthroughs in research and community programs that help more moms have full-term pregnancies and healthy babies. Join us in working together to provide children with a healthier start in life. Visit marchofdimes.org.
Free Talk Live.
It's written in legalese. If you don't have training in reading that crap, it might as well be a foreign language. Mm. And as you pointed out, it doesn't matter if you can read it.
I thought I had them dead to rights. And these bureaucrats, they just like, no, we do whatever we want here at the zoning board.
Yeah, that's right.
And you'll kiss our butts.
Peon. Surf.
You'll
slave.
You'll do what we say.
Yeah. Why label them citizens?
Oh.
Why not just call it what it is? You're a serf. You're a slave. Well, we're the freest slaves in the world. If you don't like this slavery, you should go to some other country and be a slave. At least we got cell phones and TV and beer.
Do have beer.
Our masters let us live a pretty nice life. They let us keep 40% of what we earn.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin? Any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Listen, you've heard the commercials before. Whether you owe $15,000 or $15 million in tax debt to the IRS or state, we can help. On a never-ending payment plan? Penalties and interest killing you? Missing tax returns? Being garnished or levied? Not a problem. If you qualify, we can remove levies and garnishments within days or even hours of hiring our firm. If you've been summoned, or even worse, receiving tax warrants in the mail, call right now. Are you a business owner with back payroll taxes? Is the IRS or state threatening to close your business you've worked so hard to build? Protect yourself and your business. Even if you've tried in the past, new guidelines could potentially qualify you today. So what are you waiting for? We can take that tax monkey off your back.
Call the tax monkey now. 800-281-6030. 800-281-6030. 800-281-6030. That's 800-281-6030.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. promote.lrn.fm.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. We're here live. You can call in. Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE, and bring up anything that's on your mind. Ferguson, we still have yet to talk about that, and that, I think, is definitely obviously an issue because the protests continued last night, from what I understood. I don't know if there was as much rioting, but there was definitely some from what I've heard in the news reports. I don't know how many fires were set last night, but the first night was pretty crazy. The toll-free number here, if you maybe were down there in Ferguson, you want to share your experience, you're welcome to do that here. You can also bring up anything that happens to be on your mind. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Plus, a little bit more from the courthouse today where we were, you and I, Chris Cantwell, and several other liberty activists in the Keene area came out this morning for Derrick J's hearing. It was not a trial. It was. It seemed as though it was a trial, but it was a hearing.
Yeah, a hearing on the merits of denying him his pistol/revolver license, which is the legal terminology here in New Hampshire for your concealed carry permit, as what most of us, most of the country would call this.
So we can talk more about that here in a moment. If you care about online privacy, you need ProXPN. It's a global virtual private network that encrypts your online data. I was using ProXPN today in the courthouse. They've got a very restrictive Wi-Fi access point. Now, they didn't used to have an open Wi-Fi point at all, but they did just recently add that. But it's highly restricted. Like, you know, you couldn't possibly go to freekeen.com, Facebook. You know, there's all kinds of sites that are locked down. And so when I connected to ProXPN, it got me around all that. That's one of the things that ProXPN can do for you, especially with their premium account. ProXPN encrypts your data connection. See, the other thing with the web connection that I was on at the courthouse is it's completely insecure. I mean, they give you a warning right up front. Yep, we can read your data that you're sending through our network.
Yeah, we're giving you this specifically for the purpose of being able to read your data.
Yep, so
it doesn't work that way when you use ProXPN.
Because they encrypt what you're doing online. So whoever it is that your service provider, whether it's a coffee shop, the courthouse, your ISP at home or at work, none of those guys are going to know what website you're visiting. And right now, they could be logging those sites. They could be logging the search terms that you enter. You get ProXPN, it stops all that. And you can do it with their free account just to test it out over at proxpn.com/FTL. But when you're ready to upgrade to their premium account, you get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access. You can even privately torrent with ProXPN. And in fact, when you connect to their Netherlands server, that gives you the best privacy protection from what I understand, as the Netherlands has the best kind of laws as far as protecting privacy of internet users and people who might be using things like torrents. So ProXPN also allows you to get around regional blocks of websites. It's pretty useful, and it's pretty affordable too when you use our discount code FTL50. That gets you 50% off the price of the annual account, breaking the price down to around $5 per month. That's code FTL50 at proxpn.com/FTL. Or pay with Bitcoin and save even more on that annual account. You get 62% off if you pay with Bitcoin and use code FTLBTC. Now, go to proxpn.com/FTL. You get it all with a risk-free money, 7-day money-back guarantee. You have nothing to lose but your privacy. proxpn.com/FTL. And again, you can start for free. And when you're ready to upgrade, use promo codes FTL50 or FTLBTC and get a great discount on privacy that is priceless. Let's go to your calls and your thoughts. We have Mitchell on the line listening in North Dakota. Mitchell, where are you in North Dakota tonight?
Grand Forks.
Welcome, sir. You're on Free Talk Live. Go ahead.
What do you know about the Netherlands?
What do I know about the Netherlands? It's cold.
No.
Well, then tell us something about
it. I get mail all the time. I get mail all the time that I've won money.
You get mail all the time. And what's that have to do with the Netherlands? Is it from the Netherlands?
Yes, sir.
Is you get physical mail, like in the mailbox, or do you get email?
Physical mail. I don't.
Oh, okay. Because I get all this email from Nigeria, and they want me to use my bank account to receive millions of dollars from a rich king.
Is it a similar scam? I mean, is it a similar thing where, like, they tell you they need to get your bank account
information? My 5-year-old grandson died last February, and ever since then.
Ever since
your 5-year-old son died, you've been getting notices from somewhere in the Netherlands saying you've won money?
All over.
From all over the Netherlands or all over the whole world? It's really hard to get information out of you, Mitchell. I'd just like to let you know. It's like we're pulling teeth here to get you to tell your story.
Yeah. I feel like pulling teeth. Like, I want to pull my teeth out from listening to him. I don't...
Mitchell,
what do you
got
know about the Netherlands?
All right. You're repeating yourself now.
What do you know about calling a radio show? Oh, my God. Yeah. I'm going to have to, like, write a primer on this.
Thanks for the call.
You have to have your thoughts together. You don't ask us how we're doing. You just say stuff.
I mean, what is a it's just a bizarre call. Like, I don't know about this. He's getting claims he's won money from the Netherlands, so he decides to call talk radio and ask what we know about the Netherlands.
Right. It doesn't sound like he's terribly familiar with the program, that he would think that this would be really interesting.
We've heard the stories out of the Netherlands about the scams that are going on.
Did you hear about all that free money that's coming from the Netherlands?
There's scams going on everywhere in the world. And so, yeah, that's news to me if I believe what he's saying. And it doesn't sound like he's really too with it in life.
Maybe that's what happened. I mean, maybe he just doesn't know how to read, and he actually got emails from Nigeria, and he doesn't understand the difference between snail mail and email and all of these different things that he's completely screwing up. Maybe that's what happened.
Mark Edge is on with us here, normally in the studio.
Oh, welcome to the program, Mark. It's good to have you with us.
He didn't want to
doing your job right now.
He didn't want to slide into a snowbank tonight on his way to the studio. So what's on your mind, dude?
I'm just wondering, has there been a normal person that has called this evening?
That's a great question.
Back to back wackos.
Are you kidding me? We can't even find normal people to host the show.
You know, there was the guy who called earlier, Rich. I would say Rich in Montana was fairly kind of typical, you know, talk radio caller. He was all about gun rights and all that.
The Constitution.
I found Rich to be the most sort of normal of the callers, but I found it amusing that he kept using the ad hominem attack as "you're wrong because you're liberal."
Yeah,
and calling me a liberal is a really hysterical thing.
And then asked you to logically pick apart why the Constitution was, you know, logically and intelligently pick apart why the Constitution was, you know, had gone awry or whatever, this government of the Constitution. And I just found it very interesting that, A, he uses a logical fallacy, and then, B, demands that you guys act logically. It was, you know, amused me.
Well, it's exactly what makes him typical, though, right? Because he's got the whole logic thing completely out of whack, and then he's you know, asking for an explanation from his, you know, talk radio.
Right. If somebody says something they disagree with you on, then they must be a liberal.
Right. Exactly. And that's then the liberals are all calling me a right winger too. Of course.
Oh yeah. You know, I mean, it's only a matter of time, right? Because if you've been on Free Talk Live now enough, congratulations, Chris, you finally made it. Someone called you a liberal here on the air. It happens all the time. You know, we're on some nights we're on progressive talk stations. Like Saturday night, we've got a big progressive talker on in Madison, Wisconsin, which is a huge progressive town. And then, you know, of course, we're on plenty of conservative talk stations as well. So it can happen in the same night where we'll have somebody call and accuse us of being liberals, and then someone else will call and accuse us of being conservatives, which, of course, neither is true. But that's what they're used to hearing on talk radio. It's either you're one side or the other, and, you know, we're outside of that box. Mark, any other thoughts you want to share?
Yeah, we just need there needs to be a new insult for libertarians. I mean, you know, like
neckbeard.
Yeah, next something that because this
man-child
this liberal thing isn't working.
Well, it doesn't. Let's see. So there are some insults, right? The other talk show hosts have some of them. Doesn't Michael Medved have one, like libertards or libertarians?
Yeah,
what's he call them?
Libertardians is what I hear a lot. You know, during the Ron Paul campaign, it was everybody was being called a Paulbot. What's the lolbertarians? Okay. Like LOL is the
losertarians.
Losertarians is another one.
Yeah, that's what it is. It's
losertarians. Is that Michael Medved? Is that his?
Yeah, that's Michael Medved. It's losertarians and with Harry Clown.
And then there's, you know, there's like creepertarian, but that's something that we more lob at each other. You know.
Hey Mark, thanks for the call, man. Appreciate it. Listening at the household tonight, snowed in with the family. 855-450 free. And you can take control of the airwaves. I am snowed in with you, Chris Cantwell, but we will not be snuggling later. I'm sorry to announce.
Damn shame.
There's more coming up here in, well, for the right price.
I got some Bitcoin.
We could talk. It's Free Talk Live. There's more coming up here.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
With autumn in the air, it's time to think about getting ready for winter. And it's time to save at herbalhealer.com. You'll find amazing seasonal savings to prepare you for the fight against cold and flu season. Like oregacillin to promote lung health. 30 capsules, regularly $34.95, now only $25. HHA Olive Leaf, the natural antiviral, normally $16.95, now 60 capsules are just $12. HHA Elderberry Power, a great flu and virus fighter, regularly $16.95, 60 capsules, now $10. Save on all our homeopathic detoxes. Choose from lungs, kidney, liver, brain, libido, or whole body, normally $26.95, now just $20. Visit herbalhealer.com and click on the Fall Winter Specials button to save on all our natural cold and flu fighting products. Also explore our Herbal Healer Academy correspondence courses that teach you how to handle your health naturally. Herbalhealer.com, healing the world with nature, one person at a time, since 1988.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at lrn.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at lrn.fm. That's lrn.fm.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up whatever you'd like by dialing in toll-free here, 855-450-FREE. That is the Pro XPN toll-free line, 855-450-3733. With you tonight, Ian here.
And this die-hard right-wing progressive, Christopher Cantwell.
You have to explain yourself now, Chris Cantwell. That's total inside joke.
We have the Skype. You can Skype us at lrn.fm if you want to give us a call there and give us some better audio. But sometimes people decide to use the instant messenger as like a place to post a blog post or something like that. These long screeds from lunatic callers like James in Arizona, who decided to chime in and say that we were, amongst other things, a bunch of diehard right-wing progressives,
which went
very well with the guy calling me a liberal just before, and other people calling us right-wing religious nuts and all of the different things that people get confused with when you break out of their ridiculous left-right political paradigm and try to explain to them that their neck has a boot on it.
Yeah, I'd say you sum that one up. The toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. Let's go to your phone calls and thoughts. Coming up, we can talk about Ferguson because I watched some of it go down via live internet feed on, Monday night, I guess, when the S hit the fan out there, and it was pretty crazy. Let's go to Adam first, though, listening in Massachusetts. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Adam.
My condolences, sir.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey, what's on your mind tonight?
Me and my girlfriend were thinking about moving up to New Hampshire, more specifically Keene. I wanted to ask if you guys had any advice.
My advice would be to escape that place without undue delay. Just stop asking questions and leave. I mean, what are you doing? If you're a listener to this program, if you care about your freedom at all, and then you're like, I don't know if I want to go to New Hampshire. You're a lunatic. What are you doing in Massachusetts paying taxes and being disarmed?
I'm going to college here, actually. I'm about to finish up here pretty soon.
Well, we have colleges here, too. It's like I have a college.
Most of my family is back here. I got out of the military and moved back here just to be close to the family. I missed them for a while. I was down in San Diego.
Out of the frying pan into the fire. Look, welcome. I'm glad that you're considering moving. Chris is just poking a little bit of fun. Obviously, we would love to have you come up here and, you know, bring along as many liberty-oriented folks. Is your girlfriend also freedom-friendly?
Ever since I started turning her on to the radio show.
Cool. Yeah, I mean, so when do you get out of college?
After the spring.
Okay. Yeah, it'll come up. That'll be here before you know it. I mean, this is a good time then to take that time frame and, you know, work an extra job or something like that and say, I don't know what your finances are, obviously, but a good idea when you come to New Hampshire is to have a little bit of savings in the bank, a little bit of Bitcoin or whatever you can have to sort of shore yourself up financially, because while some people have made it work coming here with next to nothing, there are, you know, other people who that didn't work for them. So it's good to have a little bit of a nest egg.
I've been searching around Monster and stuff. I've seen a couple jobs that would be pretty good for me.
What kind of field are you in?
Well, I'm going to college right now for geochemistry, but I have a strong background in electronic technician kind of maintenance.
Okay, so you're making bombs then? All right, meth lamps.
No. I used to my job in the military is my main selling point.
I don't think that your military job is going to go over well here.
No, I was a maintenance electrician on a carrier for a nuclear plant.
Okay.
Gotcha. Yeah, I mean, there's definitely power plants and things like that. New Hampshire's one of the better job markets. It's actually, I think it has the lowest unemployment in the entire Northeast, from what I understand. One of the lowest unemployment rates of all of the United States.
That's funny, because I know these people who are always screaming, get a job at people.
And, there's plenty of jobs in New Hampshire and lots of opportunity, especially for business owners to come in here. I was reading something the other day that I guess there was a comparison between office space being done between, I don't know if it was Worcester, Mass, or wherever it was, somewhere in Mass, and then versus Manchester, and it was like $50 a square foot in Massachusetts and $10 a square foot for the same facility in Manchester.
You know what I think would be awesome? So Adam had mentioned that he had worked in something nuclear. You know, I think it would be awesome if he came and built like a civil disobedience nuclear power plant.
Well, they're going to actually shut one down across the river in Brattleboro, Vermont. The hippies.
Yeah,
I
had a few friends that I worked with who they worked over there. I came up to visit them. They actually lived in Keene and commuted over there. I came and visited them a few times, and that was kind of my first experience up in Keene.
Keene is, I believe, within the fallout radius of this particular location. And
you better get Adam over there real quick, fix that up.
So the hippies have been working to shut down this plant for years, and they finally got what they were looking for, and so they're going to be shutting that thing down. So, you know, you were joking
about
it, Chris.
So that they can give more money to the oil companies. I'm sure they're going to feel much better about that and chop down some trees and do all the wonderful things that they're going to do to not have nuclear power.
Well, you know, you were joking about it, but if you really were serious, there will be an abandoned nuclear facility here at some point.
All right, that's it. We're going to homestead the nuclear power plant without them and
boot it back up. Get some uranium.
Well, I'm going to college for geochemistry, so I think I might be able to fuse the two to help them try to.
What is geochemistry as opposed to like Breaking Bad chemistry?
Geochemistry is basically the chemistry of dirt and being able to like test soil samples and
so you're gonna what, grow marijuana or?
You can do anything with chemistry, honestly. It's pretty much the science of everything.
Hey, Adam, any other questions you want to throw out there about life in New Hampshire? I mean, obviously, you're right across the border, so it's not hard for you to know what it's like up here.
You should have been at Keenvention, bro. It's the same. You know.
I tried to make it. I couldn't make it. I felt really bad about it.
Too busy paying taxes, I bet.
Adam, we'll see you up here when you get here. Thanks for the call tonight. Yeah. It's a fine idea.
I don't know why I kept breaking his chops. I was just having fun with it. Sorry, Adam.
Scare this guy away. No, we need people. I thought it was lighthearted enough. You know, in the beginning of the call, suggesting, what the hell are you still doing in down there? And that's really the question. I mean, if you are not in New Hampshire and you love freedom, then really you need to start making plans. I mean, because already the activists that have moved here into New Hampshire, the about over 1,000 people who've made the move thus far, these people are making a big impact here. It's actually, freedom is, you know, a possibility here, unlike in a lot of places, Massachusetts, Illinois, you know, you name the state. It's behind the ball as far as overall freedom is concerned compared to New Hampshire.
Yeah, I got a call from a guy in California the other day who actually found my phone number in some way that I did not approve of. He was just some reader who managed to track down my personal cell phone number. And he's asking me about moving here. And I'm like, well, you know, if you care about freedom and you're in California, what do you need to talk to me about New Hampshire for? Stop paying all these stupid taxes. Stop being disarmed and dealing with all the regulations of your business and just come here, you know. And people want to, I don't know, make a big fuss about it. And I can sort of understand it, right? Like, it's a big deal to, you know, pick up your life and move, but don't ask me, are you going to have a better quality of life here than in New York or Massachusetts or California? I mean, seriously, you understand that freedom is a valuable thing. You understand that people prosper when they're free. And then you're asking me about your quality of life when you come to a place where you don't have all these restrictions on your life. No, you're going to be better.
Share your thoughts here. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Chris Cantwell, did you observe any of the Ferguson madness as it was going down?
I didn't tune into any live feed. I tuned into a live feed, but it was dull when I saw it. But I did see some Vine videos on Twitter of bottles being thrown, cars being flipped. I saw some images this morning of businesses being burned down. There were some hysterical memes on... I was very upset about, you know, Twitter being all racial about the thing, but then of course there's the backlash to that, which is the racist memes and stuff like that, which I did get a pretty good laugh out of. People were saying things like, hey, nobody's gonna waiting for them to go burn down the KFC or something like that.
Oh, geez.
I thought it was pretty funny, but you know, that's what I was observing.
They were there was a lot of fires being set. A number of businesses were broken into. There was looting going on.
There was a picture of a pile of bricks, and it said gift certificates good at any store in Ferguson, Missouri.
People were robbing the Dollar Tree.
Dollar Tree? How desperate? How screwed up? I mean... It's the Dollar Tree, bro. I mean, if you load up your hands, you wouldn't be able to take bail money out of there with you if you emptied out the store, you morons.
It's so sad. It really is. And, you know, the wisdom of crowds, the mob violence. I mean, people, they don't get smarter when they're in groups. I don't know if you've noticed. I mean, there's certain things that people will do when they're in large numbers that they might not do otherwise. And
that's an interesting thing that you sort of bring up. And I sort of went into this with Rapture on some garbage podcast where we were talking about the Keene State College riots, right? That, you know, I saw a thing on Netflix, and I don't know if it was the Discovery Channel or Nature something or other, that they were talking about swarms, the gathering. And they were talking about how just certain animals run in, you know, schools of fish and flocks of birds. And the way that the flock communicates with each other to move as one and stuff like that. It was kind of crazy. And, you know, people obviously have some amount of that in their nature.
Some of it. We'll come back with more. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can take control here on Free Talk Live. Hour 3 is next.
You've heard of Black Friday doorbuster deals. Well, don't miss Lumber Liquidators Floorbuster deals. Get incredible discounts on your favorite floors at one-time-only prices. There's never been a better time to get a great deal on pre-finished hardwoods, hand-scraped hardwoods, gorgeous bamboo, top-quality laminates, and get 26-month special financing. Plus, get even more floorbuster discounts in our stores. The sale ends Tuesday. These deals will not wait until after the holidays. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Do you drink coffee? Was the last cup of coffee you had really good? Free Talk Live has teamed up with BuzzBucks to bring you the best of the best coffee. Shade grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is for every 10 people that get their coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. Get a free pound to try it out. A free pound of the best coffee. Help others one cup at a time. Coffee.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used, and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, November 26th, 2014. Silver is trading at $16.59 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,196 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $373. Antiwar.com reports Syrian warplanes attacked the industrial district of the capital city of Raqqa, the Islamic State, killing at least 63 people and wounding scores of others. More than half of those slain were reportedly civilians. Raqqa, in the northern Syrian province of the same name, has been controlled by the Islamic State for many months, and they have also taken over the rest of the province. The territory is bordered by Syrian government territory to the southwest and rival rebel territory to the west. U.S. and allied warplanes have been pounding Raqqa for weeks, but they reported no new strikes of their own in the past 24 hours, which led the Assad government to strike instead. Most of the casualties, the vast majority civilians, were killed in a secondary strike after the first strike pounded the industrial zone and rescuers rushed to the scene to try to dig people out of the wreckage. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing. 800-874-9760. Reuters reports a U.S. district judge ruled on Tuesday that an Arkansas constitutional amendment defining marriage as being only the union of one man and one woman was unconstitutional, striking down a measure overwhelmingly approved by voters a decade ago. U.S. District Judge Christine Baker said the Arkansas amendment denied U.S. constitutional guarantees of equal protection under the law for same-sex couples. The decision was the latest in a series striking down same-sex marriage bans imposed in many U.S. states. She wrote in her decision, "These laws impose unconstitutional classifications on the basis of gender in violation of the Equal Protection Clause of the 14th Amendment to the United States Constitution." Aaron Sadler, press secretary to Arkansas Attorney General Dustin McDaniel, said the judge issued a stay, meaning the law will stay in effect while appeals are heard. An attorney for the plaintiffs said he was reviewing the decision and considering whether to appeal the stay. The decision in Arkansas comes after the U.S. Supreme Court last week cleared the way for South Carolina to become the 35th U.S. state where same-sex marriage is legal, denying a request to block same-sex wedding proceedings. While same-sex marriage advocates have had the upper hand in the courts in the past year, a Cincinnati-based federal appeals court on November 6th became the first court to uphold a marriage ban. That decision by the 6th U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals created a split within the courts, increasing the chances that the U.S. Supreme Court will rule on the issue.
Hi, I'm Darryl W. Perry, and I need your help to take Peace, Love, Liberty Radio on the road. During a 104-day trip, I'll be visiting at least 10 cities across the country, speaking to people about the ideas of peace, love, and liberty, while simultaneously continuing to create daily Liberty Media. To find out more about the tour or to donate, visit tour.fppradio.com. That's tour.fppradio.com. UPI reports thousands protested an attempt by police to clear part of Hong Kong's protest encampment, and over 30 people were detained on Tuesday. Hundreds of police officers descended on a 50-yard stretch of the city's Argyle Street in the commercial Mong Kok neighborhood to enforce an injunction against the occupation by protesters who were demanding municipal elections be free of involvement from the Beijing government. After issuing warnings by megaphone to vacate, protesters and onlookers were ordered to disperse. About a dozen of the remaining protesters were arrested. One protester told the Telegraph, "I will stay here until the very end because this is my home. If we lose this site and this battle, then the Chinese Communist Party will take full control of Hong Kong and it will no longer be the home I know." By Tuesday evening, an increased number of demonstrators had regrouped and scuffles broke out across the neighborhood between police and members of the crowd. Police said 32 people were arrested. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
We, the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union, establish a TV show where I travel across this great nation eating pork in every one of our 50 states. Join me on my cross-country odyssey as I make our forefathers proud, reveling in life, liberty, and the pursuit of pork.
You really taste the cooked pork.
This stuff is fantastic.
I'm a big salt fan.
Let's pork! We're tasting prime pork dishes in every state in the Union, and I couldn't be more excited for this once-in-a-lifetime tour. You're going to be right here with me, seeing everything I do and watching every pork I taste. I'm Jim Haggerty. You know me as the host of Today Now, but I've also eaten in a ton of restaurants. Now I'm heading out on the road. My mission? Find the best pork our country has to offer.
Watch Jim Haggerty's Porkin' Across America at youtube.com/theonion.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live, and of course, you can bring up anything that you'd like. Just dial in toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com, where there are a lot of features waiting for you. Once again, that's freetalklive.com. You get to create the content right there on the front page of the website. Unlike a lot of talk show websites where they tell you what's important, our show works where you tell us what's important by voting. You can submit content, maybe a YouTube video or a blog post, something you liked online or something you thought was absolutely horrifying. You can submit it over at freetalklive.com. Other listeners can vote on it. And we'll talk to you, of course, about anything. Ian and Chris Cantwell in the studio. We go right back into your calls. We'll talk about Ferguson coming up here in a moment. But first, Liberty Phoenix is on the line in Illinois. Speaking of people who need to leave where they currently are, Phoenix, I heard you're planning to move to New Hampshire next year.
I am. Just a few days before Liberty Forum. I plan on being there about a week before it.
Very exciting. A destination to Manchester. I know that's what you it's not necessarily what you were calling about tonight, but what was on your mind?
Well, I was wondering if you guys support marijuana legalization.
No.
Well, I mean, reluctantly. If that's the only thing that's on the table, then yeah. I mean, if I've got the opportunity to vote for legalization as opposed to continuing prohibition, I'm going to choose to vote for legalization. If I can have whatever I want, then, you know, for me, full decriminalization is the best option. I would prefer there be no government statutes that apply to marijuana whatsoever. No government regulations, no ordinances, no nothing. And to me, that would be full decriminalization rather than legalization. But there's an argument that is made by, you know, different factions in the marijuana legalized / decriminalized community that, you know, there's different definitions for these words, depending on who you talk to. What do you think, Phoenix?
Well, I don't know, really. I was I've always said, you know, of course, you know, decriminalize it, legalize it, whatever we can get passed, get it passed. But I was perusing the dailyanarchist.com earlier today.
Okay.
And MK Lords has an article up there that's basically saying that, you know, decriminalization is a trap. You know,
decrim's a trap?
Yes, because the state can always twist the words. It's legalese. They can always add riders onto the bill or whatnot, or leave something out to where they can abuse someone. Because in a lot of cases, when decriminalization happens, you know, there's still raids on the shops because the federal level is always going to supersede them.
You're talking about legalization. There aren't in places where there's decriminalization. Most decriminalization that has happened thus far has made penalties less severe.
Yeah, so New York like decriminalized, you know, marijuana up to some certain point, at which point, you know, you get a fine or something like that. So it's still not legal to have. And of course, if you open up a shop and you start selling it, then you don't have to wait for the feds. The New York authorities will come and rip you a new one.
The only places where there are shops that are open where you can get cannabis is if the cannabis has been legalized and or is legal for medical purposes. So decrim, that wouldn't happen. Unless it was full decrim, in which case, then all statutes would be wiped out about cannabis, and it wouldn't be a big deal.
So there'd be no more
full repeal, I guess, is what the terminology might be.
Okay, that's
better.
A more accurate
full repeal.
Term. Sure, full repeal. Go ahead.
So there'd be less people going to jail. But one of the main points that she puts in her article is the fact that they're not going to be doing, you know, inmate releases, and that should be like one of the bedrocks of any bill that legalizes any form of medical marijuana.
I think that's a good point. Yeah, I mean, set the prisoners free would be a great idea.
Well, I mean, if you change a law, it doesn't the way the law works anyway is not necessarily that, hey, we changed the law so all the people who broke the law before, because, you know, the penalty, the crime is always treason, if you will, right? I mean, when you disobey the state, the crime that you have committed is your disobedience to the state. It doesn't matter if the action was justifiable or not. There is no justification for treason, if you will. And so I think that's
by retroactive enforcement. If it's
that can happen, that has happened with other laws that have been overturned, where they have retroactively released people. And I think that they are releasing some people from jails in California, or at least they're planning on doing that.
My bigger problem with the question of legalization, which you saw in like Washington and Colorado, is that what it does is it creates a new source of tax revenue for the state. It it takes this entire black market economy and sort of hands it into the hands of the state, and also tells a bunch of people who at one point were very wary of the state, who really were starting to realize for whatever reason that the state was not their friend, you know, that they were worried about the police coming, taking their drugs and throwing them in prison. Now all of a sudden they think the state is their friend and they're really happy to pay these taxes to go and lock up a bunch of other people for a bunch of other victimless crimes, and that I think is really unfortunate.
Well, thank you so much, guys, for your opinion.
Oh, Phoenix, before you go, though, I'm still a little confused. So her article's anti-decrim?
I'm sorry, you're right. It was anti-legalization.
Okay, okay. See, that's the thing, right? Like, these terms can be confusing. Usually legalization, my understanding is that when cannabis is legalized or whatever it is it's legalized, they create a legal structure. They have legalized it. They have taken something that otherwise should just be a plant growing in the ground, and they have created legalities surrounding it. They have created statutes, laws, ordinances, things like that, political structures, bureaucracy. And so in the case of legalization, they would be taking it from an illegal status, making it a legal product, meaning that they're also legalizing it and adding all this bureaucracy, treating it like alcohol regulations. You know, like the proposals usually are that the Bureau of Alcohol or whatever will be the ones that'll handle marijuana. And so basically they then take it out of the hands of average criminals and put it into the hands of the real criminals, which is the state. And so that's, to me, the real problem with legalization. I like your term, full repeal. That makes the most sense. Just strike all of the laws, strike all of the statutes on the books, and do not add more of them. I don't know how possible that is politically, though.
The idea, I think, you know, when you have those situations where they create these legal structures around it, I think that they're very negative. And if people wanted to go and repeal some laws, hey, I'm never going to argue right. with anybody for repealing laws. When people want to create new tax revenues for the state, I am hostile towards that in every way.
Phoenix, you were saying, go ahead.
That two word term that you would want to use for that, full repeal, I don't think it goes far enough. I think you need to add two others. Full repeal with retroactive enforcement. That's what's needed.
Yeah, I'll go with you there. Thanks for the call tonight, Phoenix. Appreciate that. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
I'll be glad to have him in New Hampshire. Sounds like a good guy.
Absolutely. And this is why, you know, bringing people who care about freedom together makes sense. The legalization, you know, variants that you have so far in the United States, Colorado and Washington have implemented. There's now Alaska, I think, passed it, and Oregon as well.
Interesting.
They also legalized. You didn't hear about that? Yeah,
About Alaska. Yeah. I mean, I think you'd have a heck of a time trying to grow it there. Well, I mean, you'd have to do it indoors I imagine. Yeah.
They passed it, so we'll get to see how they approach things and if they do things a little bit differently. But if you've actually got a state legislature that has anarchists, and voluntarists who've been elected to it, then that's going to change how the discussion happens. Because here in New Hampshire, I don't know, have you gone to the state house yet, Chris Cantwell?
Just to smoke weed on the steps.
That's happening next year, too, on 420. But coming up, you'll have the opportunity to carpool on up to Concord for these different hearings. So, like, right now in New Hampshire, the election season happened. What's happening next in Concord is that they're going to appoint people to different committees, like the Justice Committee. So the Justice Committee would be the one that would be hearing any cannabis change kind of legislation. And Mark Warden, who was probably the best liberty legislator of all of them. He won 2 years the Liberty Legislator of the Year award from the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance. He sat on the Justice Committee. And having somebody like that on a committee like that changes the way the discussion happens. And then when free staters and liberty activists from across New Hampshire come in to testify, you change the tone of a room. You change the tone of the discussion that's going on. In Concord, almost every time I'm there, there's only two factions in any given hearing. The Liberty people and the people who work for the state. And those are the only people who come and testify on things almost every time.
Yeah, these guys are just there saying, hey, we want to cling to some faction of power. And we're like, no, we're taking it away.
Well, not quite yet. It's happened in a few places, but the more people we can get here, the better. Go check out freestateproject.org. There's more coming up here on Free Talk Live.
Did you know by age 50, half of all men have an enlarged prostate? This means more urges to urinate, longer bathroom trips, waking at night to urinate, or issues with sex. If this sounds familiar, call us now, because we're shipping free bottles of Super Beta Prostate to listeners of this station. Super Beta Prostate is a non-prescription formula guaranteed to reduce the symptoms of your enlarged prostate. It's yours free. Pay only shipping and handling. Just call 1-800-856-4195. In clinical trials, the ingredient in Super Beta Prostate was shown to reduce urges to urinate, improve bladder emptying, reduce waking at night to urinate, and improve quality of life. This Super Beta Prostate free offer is for listeners of this station, but it won't last. Don't wait. Just call 1-800-856-4195. That's 1-800-856-4195. Call 1-800-856-4195.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, plenty of time for you. If you dial in now, the toll-free number is 855-453. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online. Go to freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features that we share with you there. The we tonight is me, Ian.
And Christopher Cantwell.
And if you want to get yourself some gold and silver, I would recommend you check out silver.freetalklive.com. You can get hooked up with some awesome silver and gold pieces through Midas Resources. That is the company that's actually behind the company that distributes Free Talk Live. So our distributor is GCN, the Genesis Communications Network. They are owned by Midas Resources, and Midas Resources has been selling gold and silver for a long time. They do a great job at it. And if you don't have the internets or you prefer to talk to somebody on the phone, you can call them toll free at 877-857-9938. That's 877-857-9938. So silver and gold, great alternative currencies. Historically, they've done a great job at holding their value in comparison to government money.
Never been worth zero. Can't say the same thing for fiat, folks.
So check them out. They're beautiful. A lot of these silver pieces are amazing, just wonderful things you'll treasure. And also the gold is there, too. Go to silver.freetalklive.com. All right. So we were teasing this Ferguson possible discussion here tonight. And I wanted to share what I had experienced in watching this. Obviously, it's not the same to watch it through a Ustream channel as it is to actually be there in the thick of this. Not that I would have wanted to be there in the thick of this. I mean, this was a pretty bad situation. Yeah. So on Monday night, we wrapped up the show, and I had linked into a Ustream channel that the Drudge Report had placed on the top of their website. It was the most convenient one. I posted a question on our Facebook page, hey, what are the other channels that are running this? And, I didn't get any really good options. So this was the one I was watching. It was a channel that was actually being, and it took me a little while to realize this, she kept talking about people pushing her, and I realized finally she's in a wheelchair. So, so the camera woman was in a wheelchair. And, like, the thing she was saying, you could tell she had been around for a while. Like, she'd been to her share of protests, and she'd been tear gassed before. So she had experience. She seemed like, she knew what she was doing to some extent.
Yeah.
So it was interesting to kind of watch her and listen to where she was, what she was saying while this was all happening. And, in the beginning, when what we were describing on the show was that what I was seeing was it was outside of the police station and the courthouse, all in the same building, apparently, in Ferguson. At least that's where she was. That's maybe there's another courthouse, but I doubt it. So they were outside of that. There was a line of cops, and there was a bunch of protesters, maybe hundreds of protesters. And it was relatively quiet. I mean, there was some shouting going on and chanting and sort of protestery sort of things. But things didn't really start to go crazy until after the show finished. So after about 10 o'clock at night, I was doing the archives here. Sort of there's a process, you know, behind the scenes that I do. And I'm just listening to the feed just to, and then switching back over to see, you know, if I hear something interesting, well, what's happening. And things just started going crazy. The cops started shooting tear gas at the protesters. And I'm sure there was some sort of excuse about a protester throwing a bottle. I think I heard something about that, which, of course, is probably a cop, as the lady who was actually holding the camera acknowledged that there's a good chance that these are actually agent provocateurs rather than protesters.
Why,
you never know.
I mean, you never know, but I mean, why is that always the go-to? I mean, why is it so surprising? And I mean, it's funny to me because, like, again, we had a similar discussion about, like, the riots at Keene State, right? Mm-hmm. Me and Rapture, and, you know, Rapture's kind of like a conspiracy guy, and he goes into, well, why now? Why is this happening? I'm like, because people are effing lunatics and want to throw stuff at people.
Yep.
And they're angry, right? So angry people get angry with government, and then they throw stuff at government agents. This doesn't surprise me. I don't think that they need to plant somebody in a crowd to accomplish something like this.
I think you're right about that. But on the other hand, there certainly have been no shortage of instances where, you know, you can't prove it. But I remember one of the classic ones was where the agents provocateur, the alleged agents, were actually wearing the same army boots that the cops were or whatever. You know, like the same kind of goose-stepping looking boots.
The jack boots.
Yeah, the jack boots. And so there was like real hard evidence that these guys were actually cops, and they kind of had the cop haircuts and things like that.
See, this just drives me nuts because, I mean, like, this happens to me, right? Like, people are like, wow, Catwell's a cop, you know? Like, I get this all the time, and I'm like, and you know, sometimes I like it, right? Because, like, people mistake me for a cop all the time. They see the two-way radio. They see the handgun. People are like, do you work here? Are you a security guard? Are you police? You know, help me, you know? And I'm like, no, I'm an anarchist. I hate the government. And they're like, what? You know? But I don't know. There's always that, like, find the Fed game being played. And
I think it's
everything.
A dangerous game. I think the find the Fed game is a dangerous game, and it's a paranoid one, and it doesn't lead to good things.
No, it doesn't. You know,
it's not welcoming. Because
it's like I said, though, it just doesn't surprise me that people get angry and throw stuff or even burn down buildings. Like, I'm surprised it doesn't happen more frequently, frankly.
There were a lot of buildings burned down. That was one of the other things that was shown on this video feed. At one point, Walgreens caught on fire. Little Caesars looked like that got totally burnt down. There were multiple storefronts that had their windows smashed. Yeah. Smash and grabs, people going in, grabbing stuff, running out, sort of all that stuff going on. At the same time, the police likely using way too much force than was necessary.
Using way too much force, more force than was necessary to deal with people who are arsonists and throwing Molotov cocktails?
That's not what I'm saying, necessarily.
I mean, let's talk about it. I mean, what's the appropriate use of force for people who are burning down buildings and rioting in the street?
Well, I can't say how the police behaved in the case of the people who were burning down buildings. I would hope that they apprehended the people who were involved in that, because that's actual property damage. But, you know, the supermajority of the people there are not violent. They're not bad people, necessarily. They're just people who are frustrated. And I think that, you know, it's difficult when you're going out to protest, because the one thing you can never control, and we learned this with the 420 celebrations here in Keene, New Hampshire, the one thing you can never control is who shows up.
Right.
If you're having a public event, any fool, jackball, undercover cop, angry nutcase, whatever, anybody can show up at a protest.
Yeah.
And you can't control them. You can't tell. You can try to influence them. You
right.
can, like, hey man, hey, chill out. It's all right. Hey, chill out. Back down. You know, like, whatever. You can do your best to try to influence these people, but ultimately, you know, if they go crazy or they do something stupid, your best just step away.
Right. And once things start going down that path, I mean, it's very, like, control can be lost very rapidly, right?
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, again, to the Keene State College thing, where I went down there hoping to see some, like, righteous anger at the police state, right? I'm thinking, hey, these guys are, you know, angry with the government and stuff like that. And then
you
I
saw
find
some
out
of that.
Yeah, well, and then I see them, you know, waving American flags and chanting USA and singing the Star Spangled Banner before they start flipping over cars, chasing out reporters, beating the hell out of one another.
Yeah, there's not a lot of intelligence in these big crowds. Now, I'm actually being told by Syphase, one of our online producers. He says, I've been using the wisdom of crowds inappropriately, incorrectly on the air. He says that I've misunderstood it or mischaracterized it. He says it's not about the wisdom of crowds of protesters. It's not even saying all crowds are wise. It's just talking about that wisdom that crowds do have. For example, the book is quite pro-free market. Apparently, it's a book. The market being a type of crowd that has wisdom that individuals don't, i.e. the invisible hand. However, I will say that when I'm talking about crowds, I'm talking about crowds. And I don't see a whole lot of intelligence when you've got crowds of people, especially crowds of angry people.
Yeah, I could see like the wisdom of a crowd in terms of market economy. Yeah. However, when we're talking about lunatics race rioting in the street... Yeah. That's another story.
Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. You can take control of the airwaves here on Free Talk Live. More coming up.
For all our loyal listeners, it's time for another giveaway. Over the next 30 days, our friends at SupernaturalSilver.com are giving away six 16-ounce Supernatural Silver Liquid, valued at nearly $100 per bottle, or their skin and body gel, priced at $49.98. All you have to do is enter and win at GCNLive.com. Hurry, contest ends December 5th. GCN can give you and your loved ones a fighting chance with the Supernatural Silver Giveaway at GCNLive.com.
This holiday season, give the gift that keeps on giving, an in-home freeze dryer from Harvest Right. With your very own freeze dryer, you'll be able to freeze dry the food your family loves. Because we live in uncertain, difficult times, what better way to show your love for your family than to buy them a gift that helps them preserve food they can use now or in 25 years? Go to HarvestRight.com and find out how you can get your in-home freeze dryer. Layaway is available. That's HarvestRight.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com. Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org. You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
This is the Onion Week in Review. Researchers at the University of Washington report that they have successfully trained 7-year-old chimpanzee Makoko to do all of the tasks necessary to conduct a 3-year study on primates. According to the scientists, Makoko has efficiently learned to turn in thorough analyses of behavior in chimpanzees, fill out all of the necessary paperwork to ensure compliance with the Animal Welfare Act, and even apply for supplemental grant funding from the National Institutes of Health. Sources within your office reported today that the guy on the third floor with two computer screens on his desk is not f***ing around. Co-workers said that the man, currently working with at least 3 programs open on each screen, was absolutely tearing it up, with sources adding that watching the man run a group video chat while dragging 2 separate Google documents to his second screen was like something out of Minority Report or something.
Jesus, he's just dragging things from one screen to the other like it's nothing. He's going balls to the wall over there. Christ, man, I don't think he's blinked in 3 minutes.
This is the Onion News Network.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you want. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Drop by freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we have waiting for you there. There's also some great businesses with which we would suggest that you do some business, especially those who accept Bitcoin, like newageautosales.com. If you've got Bitcoin and you're in need of a car, New Age Auto Sales has late model used cars they've cared for in their rental fleet. Since they're selling their own well-maintained cars, New Age Auto Sales doesn't pass on any auction fees or transport costs. You know, when normally a dealer goes and buys cars, they got to pay those costs, so the customer has to pay that too. You save that with New Age Auto Sales. Their cars are in great condition, and they're priced to move. They can ship anywhere in the world. Go to newageautosales.com, see what they have. They're looking to become the Bitcoin auto dealer. Now, obviously, if you don't have enough Bitcoin and you see something you like, they can help you out there as well. So go check it out at newageautosales.com. Late model, well-maintained cars shipped anywhere in the world for Bitcoin. That's newageautosales.com. We've been talking about Ferguson and some of the observations. I took some notes about what I observed just in one feed, one of the, I'm sure what were a myriad of, you know, live streaming feeds coming from the protesters and looters and those kind of folks who were down there, and also the cops. You know, it did make me a little bit warm to my heart, Chris Cantwell, when I saw the cop car on fire. Because I find, you know, because at least
I like my bacon crispy.
At least there they got it right. Now, I wouldn't feel good if somebody was inside it. I don't think, you know, I don't want to see people get hurt necessarily. But, you know, the tools of the state, taking those apart, burning those to the ground. Yeah, if nobody gets hurt, that doesn't bother me.
It makes
me
a lot more sense than burning down Little Caesars. Yeah. I'll give them that much.
Yeah,
you know,
exactly.
It's like, look, if you're angry at the police, then go ahead. Be angry at the police. That makes a lot of sense to me. I don't think it's right. Good to, you know, blame Whitey and start burning down businesses.
Totally.
But,
agree. I mean, there was some protests in Mexico recently where they actually were targeting the government buildings, from what I heard.
Right.
I didn't look deeply into those stories, but you know, there seems to be some these large scale protests, like, you know, in Egypt or in other places, where the targets tend to be the government facilities. Now, again, I don't necessarily agree with violence, but at the same time, if a government building catches fire and there's no one inside of it, it's not really anything I'm going to shed any tears over.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, a police car is a tool of oppression. It is a symbol. It's a very powerful symbol of oppression. And it would seem to me that, you know, hey, if you guys want to go light some fires tonight, that would be the things to be setting on fire.
Not
certainly.
Walgreens, not Little Caesars. I mean, just so, I mean, so within these groups, you've got people who they just don't give a damn and they're willing to just destroy. They want an excuse to get into the streets and destroy things.
Right. And people who want to rob the Dollar Tree because they've got really good economic sense.
Oh, and apparently, they also robbed the very same store that was robbed by Mike Brown, the guy young man who was shot by the cop.
Well, wasn't that swell of them?
Sparked all of this in the first place. And
well, somebody's got some cigars to smoke tonight. Good for you.
And apparently, the owner of that store had never filed a police report. He never called the police.
He was probably terrified.
No, in the original situation.
No, I know that. You know, that was the thing I had sort of written on that too about. You know, there's a lot of reasons why somebody might not feel comfortable about calling the police. Have you seen that rap song kind of got around in libertarian circles on Facebook called This Is What Happens When You Call the Cops?
Yes. Yeah. That was pretty good.
I love that. Yeah. I forget the name of the artist on that, but he
kind of cobbled together a bunch of different bad cop videos. And,
yeah. And it just sort of, you know, they'll beat you up and everything. You know,
it was a good rap song. I thought
it was very good. And that's really what happens. It's like, you know, hey, I have been robbed by somebody, and now I'm going to call the guy who taxes me. I don't think it's a good idea.
Let's go to, I believe, Albuquerque, listening to Kiva. We've got Mike on the line. Hello, Mike.
Hey, guys.
Hey, what's on your mind?
I'm kind of new to the show.
Welcome, sir.
I hear what you're saying about Ferguson, and you know what? It just irks me to no end.
What part?
The part that an illegal alien shot and killed a cop in California, and where was the outrage then? Where were the people?
Why would people be outraged over a cop being shot?
Well, you know what? Our president just gave people amnesty.
He's not my president. And secondly, I don't care about people living here and trying to make a better life for themselves. But what's the outrage about a cop being shot? I mean, look, it's tragic when any human...
It was an illegal immigrant who shot him, Ian.
Right. Well, where was Eric Holder's outrage?
I don't think Eric Holder cares. Eric Holder cares about Michael Brown, for that matter, by the way. The Obama administration cares about as much about anybody in this country as slugs do. I mean, the Holder is out there to wield the power of the federal government to gain power for the federal government.
Didn't he retire?
No, I think that you're thinking of Chuck Hagel, the Secretary of Defense, perhaps. That was the other big story this week.
Mike, give me a little more info here. I mean, so what's the allegation? Why was the cop stopping this guy in the first place? Do you know any of the backstory, or did you just hear a rumor?
No. The bottom line is, the guy's been deported 3 times. He's been kicked out of the country 3 times.
But did he actually hurt anybody?
That's probably why he's so pissed off at the police.
Right. I mean,
You know what? I don't know why the cop was stopping him. I have no idea.
Okay.
But what I know is that a cop was shot by an illegal alien who's been kicked out of the country 3 times.
That's not a problem, though, right?
Is my assumption, I guess where you're coming from is that you just presume it's bad that someone's an illegal immigrant, and you presume it's bad that a cop is dead, right? Those two presumptions exist?
Of course I presume it's bad that a cop
Why?
Is dead. I presume
do you,
it's bad.
Do you think that police officers are generally good people who help?
Well, the ones that I know are.
The ones that you know are, and how many pot smokers have they imprisoned or?
Oh, I don't know.
Just lock people up for having plants and throw grenades at babies.
Are they your friends?
But you know what? But so why are you so down on cops?
Because police are violent, dangerous people who kill and kidnap.
They hurt peaceful people.
A 280-pound man threw this little guy around his store like a rag doll, and you're
who
saying
through wait what well, hold
but
on
you know what?
I think
wait,
now he's
down,
talking about
down.
Michael Brown in the store. He's changing
yeah what are you talking
here.
About what store where I want to make sure you're clear.
Okay, you just said allegedly Michael Brown robbed the store. Well, it's on video.
Yeah, no, I'm certain that Michael Brown robbed the store.
I said allegedly.
Okay, no, his accomplice, you know, cop to that. I mean, I think that's there's the video of it. The video's a little bit fuzzy, but his accomplice corroborated it. I mean, there's not a whole lot of dispute as to whether or not
it's one thing if you're going after a violent criminal, but if you're just going after somebody who tried to come here to make a better life for themselves, then, you know, I don't know what the circumstances were there, but obviously the guy really wanted to be here. He got caught 3 times and sent back. I mean, presuming, again, we don't know anything else about the situation, but presuming that he was defending himself against an aggressive person wearing a badge and a gun, then, you know, is that necessarily wrong?
No, it's not necessarily wrong. But also, the grand jury determined that the officer was defending himself against Michael Brown.
No, I'm talking again about the other situation.
You're talking about two different things here. I'm actually on the same page as you with the Michael Brown thing. I do think that Michael Brown was a violent, dangerous criminal, and that he went for a cop's gun and he got he got himself shot.
But there's
no
evidence. What I was talking about was the incident you brought up, Mike, which was the alleged illegal immigrant down in California. There's no evidence that you've provided that this person was actually a danger, besides the fact that he shot a cop. Now, he may have shot the cop in self-defense because the cop was trying to kidnap him.
And he may have. I guess my point is, and this is what I'm trying to contend, is that there's so much outrage about this Michael Brown that got killed, But where is the media coverage about the cop that got killed?
I don't care.
There's always cop coverage. I mean, the cops get coverage all the time. You probably just don't live there.
Sure, they're holding a parade for the SOB now.
Thanks for the call, Mike. If you go down to wherever the hell that was in California, I guarantee you there's some article in the newspaper about it. Well, thank goodness not every dead cop gets national coverage. There's more coming up here. It's Free Talk Live. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right, General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for $35,000. You heard right, that's 5,000 square feet for $35,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100 foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait. So call 866-91-STEEL. Lock in your price now. Call 866-91-STEEL. That's 866-917-8335.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
I love my magic mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found my magic mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My magic mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to mymagicmud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. Mymagicmud.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Moments remain, but enough time for you. If you dial in right now, 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number. And that toll-free number brought to you by ProXPN. That's 855-450-3733. If you like Free Talk Live, you like that we're talking about freedom 7 nights a week live here on national radio stations all around the country, internet, podcasts. You like that we're talking about freedom, bringing the word of liberty to many, many ears, or perhaps hundreds of thousands of ears all around the country and the world. And you value what we're doing. You want to see us get on more talk radio stations because we've got about 150 some today. We could have 300, 400, 500. That's all possible. Just need money to market the show effectively. And that's one of the things the AMP program is all about. It's about $5 a month from you coming into Free Talk Live. And then we use that to invest and get on more radio stations and, you know, expose new people to the ideas of freedom. They can be shocking ideas at some points.
Especially when on Wednesdays.
No doubt. So if you like what we're doing on Free Talk Live, the best way to support the show is to go to amp.freetalklive.com. And you can sign up with any major credit card through PayPal. You can use Visa, MasterCard right there on our website, amp.freetalklive.com. Makes such a big difference when you do this. Please, if you got the extra money, if you get the $5 a month, the cost of a fancy cup of coffee, if this show is bringing value to your life, imagine the value that it's bringing to people who've never encountered these ideas before. That's what we do here on Free Talk Live.
And we get those calls from time to time. I mean, we hear from people who are like, hey, I was stuck in this mindset or stuck in that mindset, and I discovered the show, and bang, and, you know, and it changed their life. I mean, we get those calls on a pretty regular basis. It's a lot of the people who moved to Keene were influenced by Free Talk Live. This program's really making things happen out there. It's one of the reasons I'm so happy to be a part of it, and one of the reasons I became an AMP supporter long before I was and a co-host of it. So I think if you're looking to spend $5 a month on something, most of us can probably swing that. This is a pretty good use of that $5.
Thank you for that endorsement, Chris. You can do that over at amp.freetalklive.com, and you get perks. You know, we sweeten the deal a little bit. Get access to the AMP only Facebook group, which is a pretty cool thing.
It is a cool group.
The AMP only
fun folks in there.
Phone lines as well, so you can get your own call-in lines. You get the AMP only podcast, which doesn't have the usual advertisements. So there's perks, there's benefits, but the number one reason to do it is because you like what we're up to and you want us to do more of it into the future. So again, amp.freetalklive.com. We go back into your calls and thoughts. Kyson is listening in New York City. Kyson, you're on Free Talk Live.
Yeah, Kaizan, that's pretty close.
Kaizan, all right, you're up.
I just wanted to point out, I think that the most obvious point, which no one seems to be making very much, is that black racism is the driving element which is controlling the story. We've got people like Jesse Jackson, Al Sharpton, and Louis Farrakhan, which are leaders of the black race, of which there are no...
Whoa. That's a ridiculous statement. The idea that those three men are leaders of the black race. There are so many people who are black who would so totally disagree with that statement that you just made. You do understand that blacks are humans and they're individuals and they have different belief systems.
Yeah.
They're not the same mind. They're not like some sort of hive mind. I mean, what?
And the ones that choose to have leaders often have, you know, better minds than to go after Jesse Jackson and Reverend Al. I mean, Walter Williams over at LouRockwell.com is a very brilliant black Austrian economist.
Right.
And,
I mean,
you know, there's plenty of examples out there, but
it's ridiculous. It would be the equivalent of saying that Bill Clinton and George Bush are white leaders. I'm sorry. I want nothing to do with those
people. They happen to be white leaders, but they're not the leaders of the white race.
Right.
But they're the most prominent ones. The people you mentioned seem very obscure.
Those are the ones that MSNBC and the liberal left-wing media give us. Yes, but
the media wants to dumb it down. They want you to the media. This is the media's narrative, and you're parroting it.
I understand.
Kaizan.
But let's just go take his point and go forward. What do you want to get to, Kaizan?
I certainly think that privately and secretly, if you ever talk to black people, they're ashamed of Jesse Jackson and Al Sharpton. But I also
is
think
that just what you think, or have you ever talked to black people?
Oh, I've talked to them a lot, okay. More than anyone.
Twice.
But I also think that
more than anyone. That's a pretty big claim.
There's a more yes, I know it's a big claim.
Mm-hmm. Is your girlfriend black?
I think that the whole world changed maybe in the 1960s, and the dominant form of racism became black, not white. Just as the dominant form of sexism.
That's a ridiculous claim, too. There's plenty of racists out there of all different shades. Thanks for the call tonight, well, Kassan. Toll-free number is 855-453.
I would have liked to have... I'm sorry that we lost your call there, Kassan, because I think that you might have been onto something. He was a little bit off, but, I mean, it does seem like very popular now to, like, hate whitey, right? I mean, the world is blaming white males for everything right now, and it's one of the reasons that I get really... I jump into these racial things, you know, and these gender things, mm-hmm. because it used to be like, you know, the white men are ruling the world, and now it's like, well, let's turn on the white men and just destroy their lives. And I think that that's a wildly sick thing that's absolutely happening
well,
in society
just because
now.
It's in, I'm not saying it's not happening, but just because it's in the media doesn't mean it's the majority of the racists out there. I don't know who the majority of the racists are. I mean, I guess if you look at any given population demographic slice, there's going to be a certain portion of those people that are racist, whether they are Chinese, whether they are black, whether they are white or whatever, whether they're mulatto, you know, self-hating mulatto. I don't know.
The vast majority of racial commentary that I hear now is anti-white, and the vast majority of gender commentary I hear is anti-male.
That's
the world that we live in.
Well, but wait a minute. That doesn't mean that that's a majority of, you know, that you can't make a statement that just because somebody gets on MSNBC and talks out about racism and they're only attacking some, you know, white guys or whatever, doesn't mean that there aren't still a bunch of white redneck hicks who hate black people.
Yeah,
I mean, there's plenty of racists out
there.
There's
plenty of them, and they're not on MSNBC, but they are on Twitter,
right.
And what I see, the Twitter trends, I mean, you know, social media, I think, is very telling, and this is what we see. And
but you also see what you want to see. You see certain things that might be more
I do
likely
not
to
pick Twitter
come across
trends.
Your feed.
Yeah. I do not pick Twitter trends. When I see people talking about race, they're usually talking about, negatively about whites.
Let's talk to Jan. She's in New Hampshire. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Jan.
Hi, how are you?
Hey, what's on your mind tonight?
Well, you know, what's on my mind is I can't get over the amount of people that are employed by the government that we allow to carry firearms. I was in Social Security. I've been on Earth for a while, so I'm collecting Social Security. And I went into Social Security, and there's an armed man there with a gun the size of, I can't even tell you the size or what caliber or anything, but I said to him, have you ever used that gun? And he said, no. And I said, well, have you ever considered the fact that you're carrying it gives you the opportunity that you might have to use it someday? Now, if you didn't have a gun, what would you figure out to use to protect yourself? I'm sure when it comes in the flight or fright mode, you figure something out. And I just think it's too easy to arm people and give them the opportunity to defend themselves.
Well,
with guns.
Well, in the beginning of your call,
there's an armed man in the studio, so I don't know what you're all upset about.
Well,
I hope the guy works at Social Security. He should use a gun on himself.
At the beginning of your call, Jan, I was on your side where you're talking about concern about armed government employees. I mean, I have that concern as well. I think there are a lot of government guys that are armed, and they're going to use those arms against peaceful people. That's a concern I have. But an average person with a firearm, that doesn't bother me at all. I mean, these are people who usually have guns to protect themselves. Where are you from originally?
From West Medford.
North Korea.
Westminster?
No, West Medford.
West Medford. Where is that?
It's outside of Boston.
Figured.
Beside Arlington. And
so you're somebody who lived in Massachusetts and you moved up to New Hampshire and guns make you uncomfortable?
Yeah. But they make me uncomfortable no matter where I am.
Are you living in New Hampshire permanently, or are you just visiting?
No, I don't know if I'm going to live here permanently, but I've been here for 20 years.
How do you feel about the government? Is it too big, too small, or just the right size?
I think they've got too much power.
Too much power.
You know,
okay.
It's supposed to be for the people, by the people.
Mm-hmm.
That went by the boards. I don't know when. When's it been for the people and by the people?
That went by the wayside before the term was coined, right? Like the government's been a scam from the dawn of time, sweetheart. It's not a good thing.
I know. Was it ever in place? I don't know whoever made that up, but I don't know that it ever happened.
You know what I think you should do, Jan? I think you should get in touch with the Second Amendment Sisters. And reach out to them and have them give you a gun training course. Get out onto...
that sounds great. So when I need to use it, I'll get you right between the eyes.
There you go.
Well, yeah, I mean, it's not a bad idea.
Now she's threatening to shoot radio hosts. This is what it comes to. I'm due at hour three.
No, the idea was that, you know, then you could get some familiarity with a gun. If you go to a training class, you'll understand this is just a tool. It's not something you need to be afraid of. It's any more than you need to be afraid of somebody carrying anything else that they could, you know, stab you
cars!
With or something like that.
Cars!
Cars, for sure. That's a great example, Chris Kant. Well, thanks, Jan, for your call tonight. Check out the Second Amendment Sisters. Or you might want to consider leaving New Hampshire because guns are kind of, you know, part and parcel of the culture up here. And we'll see you tomorrow night online in the meantime. FreeTalkLive.com, ChristopherCantwell.com. Have you?
This is novelist Tom Robbins. When my mother was diagnosed with glaucoma, her conservative Virginia physician told her there was only one treatment that might ease her pain and save her eyesight. That treatment was medical marijuana, which he could not prescribe. I offered to get her some and teach her how to use it effectively, but my father objected because marijuana was against the law. So my mother, who loved to read and walk in nature, was condemned to grow cruelly, unnecessarily blind. Tragedies like this happen all the time, but they don't have to keep happening. To learn more about medical marijuana, call the Marijuana Policy Project at 1-877-JOIN-MPP or visit them on the web at mpp.org.
Gabino lives in Palcapata, Peru. He buys old appliances like irons, radios, and TV sets, fixes them up, and resells them. He saw an opportunity to expand his business and needed a loan to buy more appliances. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan, and the expansion was a success. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Cop Block Radio is up next, live after the news, on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Wednesday, November 26, 2014. Gold closed Tuesday at $1,199, up $2. Silver closed at $16.65, up 13 cents. And Bitcoin is trading around $375.77. Today's Bitcoin price is brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. The Liberty Beat is sponsored in part by Marjorie Wildcraft's Grow Your Own Groceries, homegrown food on every table. That's growyourowngroceries.org. In the news, on Tuesday, Missouri Governor Jay Nixon ordered 1,500 additional National Guard troops into Ferguson. The increase in troops in Ferguson brings the total number of troops to 2,200. That's only 900 less than are stationed in Iraq. Monday and Tuesday nights were marked by clashes with the police and protesters, and isolated looting and rioting. Officials say 21 fires were set and 12 buildings were burned. Early Wednesday, police in Hong Kong began removing protesters from a central demonstration site. Reuters reports that police began erecting metal barricades and dismantling tents used by protesters in the Mong Kok district. Witnesses reported several protesters were dragged away, while others continued to face off with the police. The Obama administration is expected to announce plans to reduce the amount of smog-forming pollution allowed in the air. The Associated Press reports that the Environmental Protection Agency will seek comments on a proposed 60 parts per billion, down from 75 parts per billion enacted by the Bush administration. The regulations would be one of the most expensive ever issued, with estimated costs of $19 billion to $90 billion. Today's edition of the Liberty Beat is made possible by eFoods Direct. redefining the way you think about storable food. They've created a menu of food that's so good, so easy to make, you'll find yourself eating it every day, even though it has a shelf life of up to 25 years. eFoods Direct is offering 10% off to all Liberty Beat listeners. Just go to eFoods Direct.